everybody. Welcome to this special edition of the ANN After Show. I'm your host, Lynzee Loveridge, and joining me today are four of my three, there's four of us all together, three good friends, James Beckett, Jacki Jing, and Geoff Thew from Mother's Basement. They're going to be joining us in just a second so we can get started on this super huge trailer watch party. Biggest one we've had yet, although I say that every 3 months, but they keep upping the ante on the trailers. So we've got 55 for you this time, and we're probably gonna have an intermission, so if you need, you know, to take a break, because all of us will for a few minutes or so, that'll hit about halfway through. But before we get started, I just want to remind our viewers that if you enjoy this stream, Anime News Network is also the home of the ANN After Show, which currently streams Tuesday at 6 p.m Pacific, 9 p.m Eastern. We just wrapped our season on Chainsaw Man, and we'll be back again after the winter season gets underway. This trailer party might even help us pick what we want to watch next. So if you enjoy this, make sure to give us a follow. We're on Instagram, we're on TikTok, we're on Facebook, Twitter, and of course, YouTube. So wherever you prefer to watch us, you will find us there. So without any further ado, let me bring in my co-streamers, people who keep coming back for this. Don't know why. They must just enjoy our company. Here is James Beckett.
Hey. Hey,
James, how are you doing?
Oh, I'm ready to suffer. I'm ready to... No, it's going to be great. I'm honestly excited. The fact that we got 55 shows is kind of insane, but just means that there's more potential for another hidden gem like Akiba Maid War.
So. Yeah, yeah. Akiba Maid War definitely went way up to the top of my list for best of the season, under Chainsaw Man. So yeah, we could find a really good one. Also joining us is Jacki Jing.
Hi, Jacki. I thought we were gonna do Geoff before me. I was about to drink my smoothie. Hi everybody.
We all got to listen to Jackie's blender before this.
I know, started. They're like, what is Jacki doing over there? Well, I knew it was going to be a long night. So I was like, I better make a really big smoothie. So I'm prepared and I'm ready to watch some anime.
Here we go. Yeah. And also joining us here is Geoff Thew from Mother's Basement.
Hi.
Is this your fourth one, Geoff?
I think so. I think winter was the first one that we
did.
Was that
or winter or spring? How cool.
Oh, 1 year. It's our 1 year anniversary.
It is.
What better way to celebrate than with 55 trailers?
Oh, God.
that's the 1 year theme, right?
You're so trailers? Enthusiastic.
And you know that like 20 of them are going to be isekai.
Yeah,
there is a lot. Probably, yeah.
There is a lot of isekai. Some idols in there. Somewhat decent variety. This time around, I took Jackie's notes into consideration because last time's trailer party, there was a huge chunk of just stuff we didn't like very much. It was hard to chunk through. Yeah.
Very much disliked.
I tried to break it up a little bit. I didn't backload the party that much this time. So while we do still have some of the biggest shows, you know, here at the end, like usual, I didn't put them all at the end so we could have, you know, some palate cleansers in between.
You know, a trailer watch party is going to be good when you have to program it like a film festival.
you do. I mean, that's the thing with this anime stuff. You gotta like modulate what you deliver to the people. You gotta give them a little bit of like the popular stuff that they're hyped for, and then that keeps them baited for all of the like genuinely good stuff that you want to trick them into watching.
Exactly.
Plus all the crap that you have to sit through to get through to both of those.
Yeah. Yeah.
Can we quickly just talk about how solid this last season was, though?
Oh, my God.
How bad this season before it was. So I'm like, really don't know what to expect, but it really was a great season. So
I think
I'm,
it
like,
might be the best anime season that I've like lived through as an adult anime watcher. I can't, at least as far as just like how
super
stacked
strong.
It was.
It was super stacked. Yeah.
I mean, spring. This year and last year were also like crazy stacked. Like, you know, like this year,
what happened in the spring?
Like, Spy Family
I know,
dropped.
Right?
Oh my God, that's right. How was that this year?
I dress feel like that Darling was also this years. Year.
Yeah, my Dress Up Darling was,
Like, the whole last year was just insane. Wall to wall great anime the whole time. But like, this last season, I could pick 10 anime of the year contenders from like just the last season.
Yeah.
Easy.
Was Ranking of Jing's this year too?
Yeah.
So good. I was going to say, well, I was like, what would I pick? Oh, actually, it was the end of last year though, wasn't it, Lynzee?
Well, it was split.
It was split. Yeah. So the first half aired at the end of last year and the second half aired at the beginning of this year.
Okay.
But that means all the really good emotional shit was this year. So
yeah. It's been a great year.
Lynzee and I were joking that the fact that we both put it on our end of year list last year made the rankings for this year ever so slightly less impossible.
Yeah.
Because it's like, well, we already put Ranking of Kings, so that gives us another slot.
Leave it. Yeah. No, I But you don't want to let Bochy down, you know? Do you? Right. Or Bochy. You don't want to let Bochy down for that
Bochy
matter.
Bochy or Bochy,
Bochy and Bochy crossover. We need Ranking of the Rock. That means
Ranking of the Rock.
That's good. That would be a good one. Speaking of top tens, that's actually a good segue because we will be giving our top fives from this trailer watch party. So, and we would like the rest of the chat to participate as well. So make sure that, you know, you're taking notes as we go of things that stand out to you, because we're going to talk about the ones we liked the most at the end. Another couple quick reminders. I mean, we've mentioned a few times, like, Jackie's got her smoothie. You probably are going to want snacks and refreshment as we go. Again, there will be a intermission this time in case any of us, you know, need some refills. Also, if for some reason this stream goes down, never happened before, always a possibility. We will still be up on Facebook. So like try and remember your Facebook passwords. Okay. And just like run over there and log in for the first time in 6 months.
Maybe ask your mom or your dad if you can log into their Facebook.
Or grandma or something like that. Sorry, guys.
wonder how long it's going to be till we're saying the same thing about Twitter.
I literally can't log into Twitter on the web right now. So like now, I guess it just won't work.
We're also on Twitter Spaces, so if you go to @anime on Twitter,
How long until Elon gets dumped by another woman? That'll be the breaking point, I think, when it just all crashes and burns.
Does he even have a girlfriend right now? Anyway, go over to @anime on Twitter. You won't have to scroll very far. This is streaming live there right now, so you can also watch it on Twitter. So without further ado, should we get started?
We should, because this is going to be a long night. And I also think when an anime trailer is just awful, we should all just go next and not discuss too long.
Yeah.
Because
otherwise we'll be here
forever. Just go like this. Give the veto on screen.
We're like, what is, oh my gosh, why is the show escaping me right now?
The Voice?
X-Factor. What's the other one? We're all like, you know, where they hit the X's.
America's Got Talent?
Yeah, America's Got Talent. How can I forget the name of that show? Yeah, so we'll all just be like, as soon as it starts,
A stinker, just, you know, give us the X. If we get four X's, make it a majority, or that's more than a majority.
Oh my God, if we get four X's, we should just end the trailer. Like, just go to the next one. Yeah.
Stop. No, this is no good. All right, guys, we're making up new rules as we go.
Yeah.
This was not discussed beforehand, but I think it's a good idea. So let me just get this presentation started, because StreamYard loves me now and lets me do whatever I want. So here
and always works without fail.
Not all good.
This is the first one. All right, there we go. This is Record of Ragnarok Season 2. The animation for the first one sucked, but Netflix is giving us more, so. But I'll be honest, like, the cuts that they have for this trailer don't look
These are
bad.
All the good cuts. These are literally every single good one they've got for this season, probably.
I mean, the general production values look a little bit stronger than the first season. Like, I'm seeing some better compositing techniques, I think.
Are they fighting in the Colosseum of Rome?
I'm not going to lie. The concept of this anime is totally up my alley personally. Like, it's just looks like action and weird characters.
Yeah.
But the animation was so bad, I just could not get into it. So.
Read the manga. It's a read the manga one.
Yeah. Because it does look like something I would enjoy. But then I was just like, I just... I was being a little animation snob about it, but I don't know. I like the characters and everything I see. I'm like, I'm interested.
Yeah, the character design's really good. So if you guys didn't watch the first season, this is about gods and humans like battling it out because the gods are sick of us and want to just destroy all of humanity. So.
Yeah, so it's like the strongest human beings in history versus deities in like a battle roy, or not a battle royale, but like a sort of round robin tournament. Anyway, yeah. my big problem with the first season outside of the animation was just like there were too many flashbacks. And it just like they'd get into the fight and then they'd like have to go back and explain everything that makes both of the characters significant before finishing the fight, and it just felt really awkward.
Oh, so yeah. It's kind of like that sounds a lot like my issue with JoJo's a lot of the time, where it's like, stop telling me what you did or what you're about to do and just like attack the guy, please.
Yeah, it's like that, but like worse, to a more of an extreme. Because like
I kind of love it with JoJo's though. Like it's just almost silly, like the buildup of like it just I like it.
Yeah. I mean nothing's better than the next you're going to say level of like games that happens in that series, but
yeah. All right, the next one is also coming to Netflix, and admittedly this is one that I'm looking forward to.
We've been burned before.
We have. I have trouble.
Yeah, I just saw it. I just got scared. And not because it's Junji Ito in a good way. Like I was like, oh no, because the anime was so bad.
Yeah. So this is this trailer specifically is about Tomie, which is one of his iconic horror characters. Yeah, yeah.
I don't know. That was such a teaser. They didn't give anything on that.
I'm just short. My prediction gonna be bad. That's my prediction. Like one, it's a Junji Ito adaptation, and the only one of those that looks remotely promising or has ever looked remotely promising is that Uzumaki, which is in like development hell right now.
Wasn't that supposed to come out like last year? And then
that's been delayed quite a few times at this point. I have hope for that one because Hiroshi Nagayama, I think, or Nagahama, I might have his last name incorrect off the top of my head there, but is working on it. And
It's also a passion project for DeMarco over at Adult Swim. So he's throwing his weight behind it, and that hopefully will like all come together. But like Junji Ito's stuff is so hard to adapt, and the only reason that looks good is because they're like they've developed their own visual style for it. They're basically Spider-versing that production figure out something that works and is economical, and like. Obviously, Tomie is not going to be taking advantage of anything they learned there, so it's just going to be as bad as the Junji Ito collection.
Yeah,
that's my guess.
So. Yeah, yeah. I just think a lot of those concepts are just like very hard to portray in an anime. Like with manga, you see it in your own head, right? And you create these like even worse ideas in your own head. I just think it's really hard to translate through that medium. Yeah. So
I can count the number of anime that have been legitimately like scary that I've ever seen probably on one hand.
Yeah.
It's just almost impossible to make work because animation, your brain doesn't want to believe that it's real because it's a bunch of cartoons.
Yeah.
And then it won't be scared, but maybe it'll be good. I mean, really the story is strong.
I will try it. I'm not going to put it on my list, but I'm definitely going to try it. They're supposed to be adapting 20 different stories for it. And I'm really curious how they're going to do Hanging Balloon, which is one of the creepiest stories, in my opinion, that Junji Ito's written, which is just about these giant head balloons that start floating around a city. And then they have nooses at the end of them, and they keep finding like the original and then noosing them and then strangling them up into the sky.
And they turn into a balloon head?
Well, no, the balloon head is like a separate thing. The balloon head's like a separate thing, and then there's a rope that hangs down from the balloon with a noose, and then the person who looks just like the balloon head, the actual human, like it catches them and then
okay. It's See, weird. Like the ideas of this stuff are frightening to the core, but it's just like I don't know, it just doesn't translate really well. Yeah. But okay.
Okay.
Next.
Next is Sorceress, Stabber, Orphen, Chaos, and Urbanrama, which is the third season of this, if you've watched it. So
I'm not gonna lie, I've watched it and reviewed it And I don't know if I could tell you what is going to be happening, but we'll see.
It's really weird that Orphen
came back.
Came back and is around. It's weird.
Yeah.
I also like. I just think fundamentally, Orphen doesn't really work with modern anime character designs. Mm. It's just such a like late 90s, mid 2000s. Mm-hmm.
Okay, what is with these interstitials that look like they're from Ava? Did you see like they did those red screen flashes with that black font text? And it looks like
graphic designers who think they're slick but haven't really thought about the cohesiveness of the aesthetic.
All right, it'll just autoplay to the next one. Next, this is FLAGLIA. I think it's supposed to be bringing together musicals and anime. It seems more like an idol vehicle for this Korean boy band called The Boys.
Wait, but we're talking about
that
like
band name.
It's like actual Broadway style. Like they're singing like character songs.
I don't know if it's supposed to be. I don't know if it's be Broadway style musical or if it's more like anime stage musical. Okay. But
because there's that one show a season or two ago with like the doctor girls that sang songs.
Oh, Healer Girls is what you're talking about.
That was great because that felt a little bit more like a Broadway style.
I agree, Jacki. I'm just like, I like musicals and that did not grab me, unfortunately.
It didn't do anything. It just did probably, there's probably like a, Jacki, you're muted.
Oh, I thought
I was passionately answering. I said I got so excited when Lindsay said musicals. I was like, "Oh, are we going to hear like Cabaret or like Phantom or like some music?"
I
want that anime. Someone make that anime. But then they were just
wait. That anime exists. You need to go watch it, Jacki. It's called Dance with Devils. Go watch,
dude.
Dance.
Are you joking me right
Not
now?
Not even remotely kidding. It's a musical. Episodic anime starring a girl who goes to like it's
okay. Then I will definitely.
There's
watch
a bunch
that.
Of guys who are like demons / humans, and then there are songs, and there's a Pomeranian in it, and you just need to go watch it.
Also, not quite the same thing, but anytime this comes up, it needs to be said that everybody needs to watch Review Starlight.
Oh right,
yes,
that too,
absolutely.
That's like Utena musicals. Yeah, mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, but that one was a no.
Just looked like boring idol crap.
Yeah, this next one is Cardfight Vanguard will+Dress Season 2.
Which card one is this?
It's still Cardfight, but it's the second season of the one that's got character designs by Clamp.
Weird one. This one's a weird one.
Yeah.
I can't remember. I remember there's that one card show from, maybe it is this one, where it legitimately did not bother for a second to explain what the rules were, what the mechanics were.
Uh-huh.
And so it just became this nonsensical collage of, maybe this is it? I don't know.
I think it is this, because I think we did one, the character designs are nice.
Yeah. Like, I was just thinking, I like them.
Yeah, he's hunky. She looks
a little
bit like...
Oh, she's so cute.
Super
cute. Like, Tomoyo from...
she's super cute. They're adorable.
Production values also look okay.
Yeah. I remember the fight scenes in this being pretty, like the first season slapping pretty hard.
Oh, yeah.
Like they went kind of Gainax-y or triggery with the character, like the monster animation.
Oh, okay.
But that was just the first season, so I don't know.
This is not the one I'm thinking of. The more I see it,
you might be thinking of Build Divide or God, there's so many.
It was they were in like a digital world. It was like a digital like nighttime.
Is that Wixos?
No, not Wecross. That's a whole different thing. I know Wecross.
Okay.
I'm not gonna lie, I love the characters I've seen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like it's kind of fun. Yeah. I don't think it's worth putting on my list, but fun. I didn't exit.
Yeah.
Cardfight Vanguard's generally like among the more entertaining card game commercial anime, you know? I really like the original series because it like kind of captured that vibe of like actually hanging out in a card shop and like buying packs, opening them, changing your deck. Like the actual like card game playing experience. But then they stopped doing that because I guess it wasn't marketable, and now it's just another Yu-Gi-Oh! But it's a pretty good Yu-Gi-Oh!
Yeah.
I literally just today, my wife and I bought a Magic deck, a deck box with a bunch of boosters. So I like it when shows can actually capture that vibe instead of just throwing a bunch of cards out and making it a... But the character designs do look good, so...
Yeah.
All right, this next one is one that I actually put on my most anticipated, and it's entirely because of the staff involved. So this is the Fire Hunter. And this will be streaming on Crunchyroll. For those who were interested in the musical boy thing that hasn't been picked up for streaming yet, otherwise everything we've shown so far is Crunchyroll except for the two Netflix shows at the beginning. But yeah, Mamoru Oshii is...
Oh, that's a big one. And Kenji Kawai doing the soundtrack. Two huge things right there. Oh, yeah. Man.
Oh, can boy. You turn the music up?
Yeah.
It's over.
It's okay. This is short, and I'll replay it just for you, Jacki.
I like the music.
I'm thinking this.
Yeah. So in the aftermath of humanity's final war, the Fire Hunter who captures the swaying flame will come to be known as the King of Fire Hunters. And this is based off a novel.
I like this a lot. Yeah. I don't know why. The music I'm vibing with. I really like how the characters look. I love this world. It's just beautiful.
Yeah.
I'm going to write that down.
That like mid-2000s, early 2010s vibe of like the kind of dark fantasy. You don't really see those a whole lot anymore.
Yeah, no, I agree.
It's really cool that Oshii's been like directing again. Mm-hmm. You know, like I wasn't, what was the blood something?
Was that vampire?
The last one he did? Yeah, the Vlad really Love. Weird, Vlad Love. Yeah, that yeah. was.
Was that the one that re-reviewed the lesbian vampires?
No, Vlad Love
was the other lesbian vampires.
Yeah, I was going to say, wasn't the recent lesbian vampires?
Vampire Garden. Vampire Garden was the recent lesbian vampires on Netflix. Yeah. I'm interested in this one. If you guys didn't pick up the story, there's like these creatures that exist and fallen beasts, and they all live in this woods. It's kind of a post-apocalyptic setting because of like a after effect of this war that happened. Humans can't actually interact with fire anymore, or they'll spontaneously combust.
What?
The only safe energy source is within the body of these flameling creatures, and so the fire hunters go out to hunt them to capture them as like an energy source because they can't
use that's cool. I dig
fire
that.
Anymore. And there's also something about a comet. There's a comet involved as well.
And a comet involved? Sign me up.
But I'm interested because the way it looks is, I think James was saying earlier, is very like early 2000s kind of.
Yeah.
Like it almost looks like a Disney Kids show. Like
yeah.
So I don't know. I'm curious about it.
I just know that it just was the whole package for me for some reason, even though it was very short. Like the music was good. I liked the characters. I liked the world. Yeah. And I just was like, I wanted more. Like that was a really strong teaser. So,
I mean, Oshii's a great director.
Yeah.
Like
yeah.
He's not directing this one though. He's only writing the scripts.
He's also a good writer, so that's still good. But you know,
I really liked what I saw of Lad Love. I don't think I finished it, but I watched like the first, I think, 6 or 8 episodes, and it was really funny and really entertaining.
The concept behind that show is really weird because I think it was mostly funded by a real estate agency in Japan. Weird, just weird. Yeah,
very weird.
You got to make that money.
Yeah, you got to get it somehow. So this next one is also a sequel. I know Christopher Ferris over at AMA News Network is a big fan of this. This is a D4DJ All Mix. So let me... So these are... It's like a girl idol show, but they're not idols. They're actually DJs.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And it's got the 3D CG look.
I don't really like their eyes. The animation's good.
Yeah.
Their eyes are
very shiny. Yeah.
That's fine. It's just an aesthetic thing.
I
like the expressions. The faces are really animated. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. The expressions are really strong, and like the posing has a lot of personality to it.
Yeah.
I was gonna say, like, when are we getting some music? This is a DJ show. Like, I need to, like,
I'm definitely not watching this.
Like, me neither.
This is definitely not my cup of tea. I'm just being honest.
Yeah.
Y'all remember DJ Hero? That game ruled.
That game
never
did
played.
Rule. Yeah, I never played. I was only a Guitar Hero and Rock Band.
Yeah, Rock Band for sure. And Guitar Hero, yeah.
DJ Hero gameplay wise, I felt like it was a little lacking somewhere, but like the remixes that they put in that game, specifically like the Queen remixes.
Dude, the Queen Daft Punk remix is like one of the
so all-time good.
Oh my god, I want to hear that.
Oh, it's so good. You need
I'll have to look it up. Yeah. All right.
It's Around the World mixed with
Another One Bites the Dust,
or We Will Rock You, one of the two.
One of the two.
Nice.
Yeah. Insanely good.
That's fun.
D4DJ. I feel like I might check it out someday, but in the same way that I say that about Love Live and then don't.
You know? That's fair.
Maybe if I have like a cold and I'm like stuck in bed and
seem like something that would just be like easy comfort.
By the way, someone in the chat with the handle Need More Cats and I'm with Jacki, idol shows are definitely not my cup of tea, and it just made me really happy that someone who said Need More Cats agreed with me. I just love your handle, so yeah.
Cats are great.
Idol shows definitely not my cup of tea either. So
this next one is for James especially, and I think it's just for him.
It's just for me. Oh my god! I'm so upset. I'm not even going to bother Xing it because I know it's going to happen. Look at all of our faces.
We're all like.
Oh my god. How long is this trailer, Lynzee? Is this one of those like.
I know. Should we. Just...
It feels like it's been a few minutes.
I'm not going to let you exit. James has to watch the whole thing.
We gotta...
Oh, there's the little cat slave that got free bite. Oh god.
There's a guy in a.
How did.
What?
Now, I will say that
there she is, the gorilla.
When this first got announced, I said that the ultimate actual joke that I would respect the hell out of was if they just made a really good anime with like great animation and direction that just happened to have the same characters and plot.
Obviously,
they're not doing that.
Like occasionally the like reaction faces in this show are funny in like a retro Showa comedy type way, but that's about
To me, I was telling Lynzee this the other day. The fact that it knows that it's terrible for me actually makes it worse, because it's like watching like an edgy 12-year-old fail miserably at stand-up, but for 5 hours straight.
Yeah, it's pretty. This show's pretty excruciating.
I'm so bad.
Either James or Geoff want to tell people and for the comments, you know what the show's actually about.
Is this the gorilla girlfriend one?
Yeah, this
gorilla girl of evolution. It's about. It's kind of like So I'm a Spider, So What, where the whole class gets isekai'd. But then the main character is like so pathetic and nerdy that like he's canonically subhuman, like literally like within the magic system, he is classified as less than human.
He evolves into a normal person.
And then he evolves into a Kirito by eating the fruit of evolution. And then that fruit also makes a talking gorilla turn into a hot girl so he can fuck her, and then a talking donkey turns into a hot girl so he can fuck her. And that happens a bunch. And then they sold NFTs of it.
Yeah, they did.
Mm-hmm. It's just the absolute worst thing.
It's truly, I mean...
Why are we even reviewing that?
Because people
it
like
exists,
to see
the
people
trailer
suffer.
No! Why? Lynzee just does this to torture people. I see people assigned to some anime, and I'm like, that is just mean. Sorry, James.
Hey.
What was the other one? What was there was one that was so bad. Why can't I think of the name?
X-Arm.
Yes, X-Arm. I'm just
that had to be documented for historical purposes. That
X-Arm's significant.
That's like sending a reporter to the Hindenburg to be like, you need to be there on ground zero. So that people know what happened to you.
Oh my god. Okay. Lynzee's just or mean, like, one or the other. No, I'm kidding.
Both. Why not both? as Blaze says, the reviews on ANN were well worth it. If you want James to review the second season of Code of Evolution, there will be a poll at the end of Preview Guide. Preview Guide launches on January 4th, should run till about January 16th. A poll will go up then, and you can pick which shows you want our reviewers to watch. If for some reason you want James to review the second season of Fruit of Evolution, you know, just click that button. It could happen. And
I just want you all to know that every last one of you thinks that it's going to be really funny to make me watch him review the Fruit of Evolution. But what's going to happen this time is exactly what happened last time, where there are only so many ways to say that a show consistently sucks at the same things in the same ways all the time. And it's just going to devolve into nonsense. If that's what you want, then fine. Just know what you're getting.
Here's what you need to do.
Sorry, go first.
You got to take your reviews of the Fruit of Evolution, and then you've got to like put in like a Mad Lib algorithm to just like generate random words for it, and then you sell them as NFTs and call that commentary. Like,
you know, for the last season, I made a fanfiction.net account and wrote a 3,000-word fanfic of an episode. Because a stupid idea got stuck in my head and I had literally nothing else to say. And so I said, you know what? I want to know what happened when these two abomination animal girls had a minute alone and had to reckon with what their lives had become. Because it's,
and then we published it.
And then
So my question is, like, X-Arm did not get a second season.
No.
So how did this one get a second season?
Because NFTs must have made money.
How? Who's watching that? Who?
People are probably reading the light novels, and like it's an advertisement for those. So like, the people producing it probably just.
To be honest, the story would probably be exponentially less awful in light novel form because you wouldn't have to hear the main character speak. And the jokes could just like end when you turn a page instead of going on for minutes. So I truly believe that the light novel is a significantly improved experience.
Improved version. Interesting.
James, Julia Goodwin would like a link to your fan fiction. So if you happen to have time to pull it up.
Sure. Yeah.
Let's see if I can make that happen. In the private chat link.
First of all, how did you even find that fan fiction, James? That's the real question.
I linked to it in the review, so all I gotta do
James wrote it. Okay.
While James does that, we are going to watch Pokemon because Pokemon has a
I'm playing Scarlet and Violet right now. Violet though. So.
Are you really? I didn't buy the new one, so maybe I should.
It's just relaxing.
I mean, it's broken, but it's good stuff. So
it's just relaxing. I just go and catch stuff.
So this we showed this video during the ANN after show, and we had an article about it. But basically, this is for Pocket Monster Mezase Pokemon Master, which is going to be an 11 episode ending to Ash's journey as the lead for Pokemon. I still can't believe it's happening, to be honest.
I feel like we have to watch this again, dude, just because it's like
Ash is as old as older than James, is as old as some people here. I won't say who.
Not naming any names.
But has stayed 10 years old. So I'm just like, it's time. I think it's time. I just am like, I love Ash as a protagonist, but it's also like, it's time to hand over the baton, right? Am I wrong?
For sure.
Am I weird?
It makes sense, but I could also argue, maybe not much time here, but it's like, what if Disney was like, we're just not using Mickey Mouse anymore?
I mean, Pikachu's still going to be in it.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, Sprigatito. That was my starter. Like,
it's... I think one, the new characters look really cute, but like it's so cool that they're putting a girl at the forefront of Pokemon.
That is really cool, right?
Yeah,
you know, not just as like the
behind for the whole time. Yeah.
I mean, like, Yeah, like you could kind of argue that like May was the deuteragonist in through the Ruby and Sapphire arc, but like you can also argue no. So
well, and the very fact that like they're all sort of just destined to at some point or another fall off just ends up making them feel kind of disposable, you know?
Yeah.
In a way that like Ash never was because he was always there. And so the fact that, yeah, I agree. I think that it's a good look.
Yeah.
I haven't gotten to the end of Journeys. I started watching it a little bit on Netflix. It's just a nice show to have in the background and actually really well animated.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, the whole series has been like really well done since the character design shift for Sun and Moon.
Yeah.
They like, the show pro picked up just a ton of lessons from what was working with Yo-Kai Watch around that time and just like completely revamped the series to like embrace that. And yeah, I would say Pokemon's probably like the best produced weekly anime that's currently running.
Yeah, it looks really good. I was surprised. Like, that doesn't have to look as good as it does. You could you don't have to.
Lynzee, I think Ash... Oh, sorry. I was going to say, I think Ash, his character being retired, I think it just hurts a little bit because it just makes us realize how old we are. Like, the fact that it's, like, it's time, but it hurts. So, yeah. Anyway,
that's all I got to say. I just dropped a link for James's fan fiction in the chat. So, you know, bookmark that for later reading if you're so inclined.
Yeah, if you're going to read my fanfic, you better do the cool thing and, like, leave a good comment and kudos and all that. So
this is trash, period. No, I'm kidding. I would never, James. It's a masterpiece.
It's still a comment, so that's engagement.
Yeah, still engagement.
Oh, no. All right,
so this next one we've got, people have been asking in the comments, near at any point, but we're going to watch every single one, guys, but I'm not going to tell you what's next each time. You got to wait, all right? But, you know, for those who were really curious, the next one is BOFURI. We're going to watch BOFURI now. Nice. This is for season 2.
Look, I just need to say it because the joke happens in my head every single time it comes up. BOFURI's nuts. Okay, I've said it.
BOFURI's nuts.
Yes. I cannot, it's stupid, but I cannot see or hear the title of the show without that dumb joke happening in my head. And so now that it's out, I might be free.
Thank you for sharing.
Yeah. For those who haven't watched BOFURI, it's about this girl. Her name is Kaede. Her handle in the game is Maple. And she just like ups her defense really high because she doesn't want to get hurt and breaks the game. And most of this is her playing this VR MMORPG with her friend in a little, you know, adventuring party and continually breaking the game mechanics in new and unique ways, like by eating monsters.
And while that's not that unique for a VR MMO anime by itself, what makes this one really fun is that the devs are also characters, and they're quite upset with all of the things that she makes them update.
See, that's cool. That's a good way to spin it. I liked the 3 or 4 episodes I watched when the first season came out. I sat down with it to see if it was like something that I should consider.
She has a tentacle arm now?
Yeah, I was like, what is that? Oh, I didn't watch this one, but I actually am intrigued by this trailer.
It's really good. It's like, I would say one of the better VR MMO anime out there. Like definitely top 5 for sure. It's, you know, like it's kind of got like that K-On! Sense of humor, but with actually really, really, really strong action scenes. If you like Princess Connect, that would probably be like the closest anime I can think of in terms of like vibe and balance of
I didn't watch that one either, but I did. We did have reviews for Princess Reconnect.
Do you like Konosuba?
I haven't watched Konosuba either.
Yeah.
So
it similar to Konosuba, you think?
Yeah, Princess Connect is from the same director as Konosuba, so it's like Konosuba, but like a little more chill and laid back, as opposed to being like mean and sarcastic.
I've always wanted to watch Konosuba and I haven't, so I'm like, I don't know. BOFURI look good though. I wrote it down.
All right, so this next one is by Tsutomu Nihei, who you might know from Blame and Knights of Sidonia. This is, again, him working with Polygon Pictures for Kaina of the Great Snow Sea. So I'm going to get the muscle memory for this eventually, you guys, and then we'll just keep it. There we go. So it looks like this because it's polygon pictures.
Sure is polygon pictures up in here.
Yeah. And the story is, in a world where land is being swallowed by the encroaching Great Snow Sea, humanity ekes out a harsh life above the Tenmaku that stretches from the roots of the tops of giant orbital trees. The story centers around Kaina, a boy who lives above the Tenmaku, and Liliha, the princess of the small country Atland in the Great Snow Sea.
Green.
Why did I read any of that? And you guys are just green.
I know, literally. I was like...
Literally everything that you just said, like...
This looks okay, actually. Like, this looks not too bad. I'm kind of...
We talk shit about polygon pictures, rightfully so, because they haven't fully figured out how to, like, make faces look good. Yeah. But,
gotten better.
They have gotten better. And, like, I think that stuff like this, this, like, high-flying, crazy world fantasy adventure stuff like this and Drifting Dragons that they do is... I don't know. I think it really makes the case for their production methodology. Yeah. Knights of Cydonia is also an extremely watchable show, although considerably uglier.
So what you're saying is that they have improved over time then.
Oh yeah, for sure. Yeah. For sure. Yeah. But yeah, no, like
did they do that? Did they do that what's the giant robot Guillermo del Toro?
Pacific Rim.
Did they do the Pacific Rim show?
Might have been them.
Oh, that
I can't remember. Oh, I watched that a while.
Pacific Rim Black. It was like
might have been them. That was a pretty good one. If that was them, I'm pretty sure it was. But that one was okay too.
Yeah, it was okay.
Polygons, like their Godzilla movies, are also like uneven but interesting. They like.
God, I couldn't get through that.
Those the ones where Godzilla's like a planet? Nice.
Yeah, I didn't it's like Knights of Cydonia, but instead of fleeing aliens, they're fleeing Godzillas.
There's a very popular quote that some of my reviewers like to drop from that. Lost Thief, get in the comments. What's the ridiculous thing that gets said in one of those Godzilla movies? I don't remember what it is. It's just weird junk science or something. He'll have it here in a minute.
I feel like I remember what you're talking about. There's some real dumb shit in those movies. Yeah. Don't get me wrong. I just like... I don't know. I find it cool seeing all of, like, polygon pictures evolve over time because they like.
That's it.
Yeah. If Lost I join your religion, will I be able to kill Godzilla? Yeah, that's the movie in a nutshell. That is the entire.
My gosh, good that question. Is awful.
Thank you, Nicholas, for always coming in the clutch when I need a good soundbite.
Oh my god!
All right. This next one, I think, is just a straight fantasy. I don't think this is an isekai. However,
please be good.
If I see one of those circle tens, I'm going to get my X ready.
No, James. You're going to...
I'm only vibing with the Fire Hunter right now.
The opening shot of this trailer is one of the circle towns.
It's not a complete circle. So
Yeah. Okay, so this dude here is named Nick, and he's a veteran adventurer, but his life is falling apart because despite all his knowledge and expertise that he's devoted to his venturing party, they kick him out. His girlfriend dumps him.
Aww.
And his teammate
I hate that this has become, like, the sub trope that, like, a lot of these shows are leading in.
Yeah.
Where, like, the subtext of being a socially isolated and rejected sad boy...
I kind of like it too.
The art style and I wasn't on board, but like they're animating it really nicely. It's not, you know.
Yeah,
Geoff, I agree. At first, something was bothering me, and then it like I got over it for some reason.
I like the dragon looking girl.
The color style and like compositing is. It looks cheap, but then
But there's a giant hat in this.
But the shot,
a giant hat.
Like the shots are actually more complex than you'd expect in the
It's not just a bunch of mid shots. That's something.
Dragon Girl.
I really like the characters. Yeah, I like the Dragon Girl a lot. I saw her and I was like, "Ooh, I really like her."
But
ice cream had tentacles in it.
That ice cream did have tentacles. Like you said, it is
love her.
You know, there's been a lot of these quitting the hero's party. Like it's almost as common as reincarnation stuff at this point, and that's just right behind Isekai. So
what's that one called?
What's it called? Yeah,
that one is called "Adventurers Who Don't Believe in Humanity Will Save the World."
Oh my god, I'm gonna just put down.
I like that title a lot. That makes me.
I know.
More.
Yeah,
I like that one.
Right. So are they all like a bunch of like nihilist?
Yeah, I think while he's getting drunk there. He finds what's called a few kindred spirits who are as jaded as he is. And so that's the, you know, and they become the four group that we saw in the later half of the trailer. And they're going to form
jaded spirits.
We're
a little too close to home there.
Unstoppable team to save their bleak, depressing world. Yeah.
You know what, I'm going to be the dragon girl.
Sorry, I'll wear the big hat.
I want an isekai starring the nihilists or just the main characters from The Big Lebowski. That's what I want.
I'd love that anime.
Walter. All of them.
Let's be honest. Lebowski is kind of like an anime. Man.
It is.
You're right.
Oh my gosh. True.
Chainsaw Man is just what would happen if the Coen brothers made a shonen anime. And it's
pretty much.
Yeah. Oh my god. That's funny.
All right. I wrote that one down too. I did think it looked pretty good. This next one it's an isekai. This is animated by MAPPA. And from what I can tell, it looks like it's food oriented. This is going to be
this could go campfire, a couple of different ways.
Camping, campfire cooking in another world with my absurd skill.
Did they ever make an anime of that? Was it Dining in Dungeon or
Delicious in Dungeon?
Delicious in
coming.
Dungeon.
It's coming, and even better, Studio Trigger is adapted.
Okay. Trigger on anything. I'm like, let's go.
Sorry, that's not this show.
Don Meshia especially, it's going to be so good. I'm so stoked for that. Just thinking about it makes me not care about this.
So he's a little chef is what I'm gathering?
So he's summoned by mistake, and he doesn't have any abilities other than
cooking.
He has the unique skill called Online Supermarket, and it lets him buy modern goods and bring it into this fantasy world. And so people end up finding out that, you know, this guy can make really unique, crazy food, and he, you know, gets a bunch
of... I'm not gonna lie, this actually looks kind of fun.
Good. Yeah. The food looks so good. I don't know if it's because I'm hungry. I was like, oh, this looks good.
Into that meat, there was like some nice marbling going on in that.
Plus, like, we're not hard up for cute slimes at this point in the state of anime, but those were some pretty cute slimes.
They were really cute. I think it was the eyes or something. I was like, aw. Okay.
I like cooking anime in general, to be honest.
I never thought I'd like cooking anime, and then Food Wars. Everyone
was like, that was my first one too.
Yeah. And I was like, dude, for some reason, I get it.
Yeah. Yeah,
I made a joke on Twitter the other day that they need to make like an anime version of the Great British Bake Off, but I legitimately do want an anime version of the Great British Bake Off.
That'd be amazing. So I'm surprised someone hasn't done that.
Will Paul Hollywood be in it as an anime character though?
Of course, absolutely. And I want them to find like one of those like random US expats to voice all of his lines in English. So he'd be like, "Great baking."
All right,
this cookie next. Is wild.
Love all right, it. Next.
All right, so this next one, this is a cute one.
Paul Hollywood will be the demon king. Yeah, that too. That's also true.
Look, all right, it's this one and this one. This is Kubo. Kubo won't let me be invisible.
Yeah, I've read a little bit of this one in the Jump app. It's cute.
Oh, I reckon. Yeah, I think I looked at this too, actually. Yeah.
Kugel.
Wait, is this like a motion manga? Oh, okay, now their lips are flapping. Their lips weren't flapping for a second there.
Well, that was short.
It was super short.
Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, doesn't really tell you much, but it is a really cute type of thing. If you like, what's just I'm blanking
like,
on,
like Iyashike?
Yeah, yeah, I like Iyash. No, I'm trying to remember. Komi. Komi can't communicate.
Oh, okay.
It's kind of like an inverse Komi type thing, you know?
Yeah, the guy guy's supposed to be really bland and no one really notices him, just an average looking dude, and the girl is really cute and sweet and she notices him, and that's why Kubo as the girl won't let him be invisible. So
that's sort of
my attention span.
Takaki-san, and that's one of my favorites. So I'll take
my attention span couldn't do Komi.
Oh,
I just I tried. Like I loved her. I loved the animation. I really like the concept. And just for some reason, my ADD, my craving for violence, it was like I couldn't get into it. So I don't know. But maybe I need to revisit that one. But that one kind of reminded me of Komi, and I was like, I'm probably not going to be able to get through it, unfortunately. So
that one's animated by Pine Jam, and they've actually done some good stuff recently. Like I really liked their work on. Oh God, the one that was also about stage plays with all the girls.
Lynzee, with the tall girl.
The really like that one had like some real good like melodrama in it. I'm blanking on the name. Kageki Shoujo. That's why I couldn't remember it because it's so
the same studio as
Review Starlight. It's the exact same pre-title as Review Starlight, but without the Review Starlight part. Kageki Shoujo.
And the director worked on Rent-A-Girlfriend, which I know that one's had like mixed reception, but we'll see.
I love Rent-A-Girlfriend. I mean, you know, it's very well made. Like you can't, whatever you might think about the story, the like production quality of that show is unimpeachable.
Yeah.
But yeah, Kageki Shoujo, that was so good. Pine Jam just I hope it gets another season too.
They did Do It Yourself as well, which also that just ended.
I didn't watch that, but that one looked really pretty. Yeah, that show looked pretty. Yeah, and I do not like those shows. And even I was like, maybe.
If you only watch one show like that this season, I would say Bocchi the Rock is the one to check out. That one over like if you have to pick between that and Do It Yourself,
Bocchi the Rock's better.
Bocchi the Rock's better.
What they're doing on Bocchi the Rock is like kind of next level as far as the
it's like Bocchi the Rock I would compare to like Kaguya-sama and Mob Psycho as like
okay
I slept on that one. I have to go back and watch it.
Yeah,
you know, normally I'd say go
if you're
watch
saying on the level of Kaguya-sama and Mob, I'm like, all right, I'll put that
real
on my other list.
Yeah, no, they're doing crazy experimental stuff with the animation, like there's stop motion in it. Total mixed media.
I love stop motion. Yes.
It's Bocchi's amazing. Like normally I would say DIY is a good one to watch because it's a very good cute girls doing cute things type thing. But like Bocchi's like next level. So if you check out one, check that out.
Yeah. It deals with like social anxiety in a really realistic way with the main character and stuff.
She's like has no friends and decides that the best way to make friends is to get good at playing guitar. Cut to 3 years of practicing in her closet and not talking to a single other human being later.
I need
apparently
to watch
didn't
that.
Read the biography of every famous musician ever.
Right.
It turns out that focusing on your art to the exclusion of everything else is soul destroying, but you can make a good tune. So it's, you know.
Oh man.
So this next one doesn't have any of the emotional gravitas that we were just talking about. This is the second season of what looks like a cute show about chibi Egyptian gods. So
let's just say chibi?
Chibi.
Chibi. Oh, okay. Chibi. Oh no. This is already ridiculous. Okay. This is ridiculous.
I'm on board.
I'm so not on board.
Good opportunity to eat your snacks while you watch this.
Not gonna lie, this is cute.
Yeah.
This one of them looked really cute. Okay, the cat's cute too.
You can buy plushies of all of these.
Yes.
So you know, and they're amazing.
Reminds me of Gretzko a little bit.
I can see that.
I legit need to buy these for my wife. So I'm gonna. What's this one called?
This is actually called Suddenly Egyptian God.
This looks absolutely ridiculous.
It's funny. I think it's a short one. Like, each episode's only 5 minutes, so
yeah.
That's, you know, good. If you're just looking to like vibe to some Family Guy gags for 5 minutes.
Well, the number of, especially recently, because I remember back a few years ago, every preview gag we'd have enough short series to do a shorts roundup, and lately there's been like one per season or something.
Yeah,
and there are so many comedies that should be shorts.
But I think the shorts meta is just kind of over, because like,
yeah, there's been a couple different like things, sort of like for a while we had all those shorts, and maybe there used to be some television blocks that supported that might not exist anymore. Just like there was kind of a phase when we had a lot of Chinese co-pros, and then China was like, we can just make our own stuff and people will watch it. We don't need to do co-pros anymore. And so that kind of ended. We'll see what the next weird fad is.
I think shorts are just like a casualty of the switch to streaming more than anything. Cause like,
I can't really stream a season of shorts.
And why bother making TV bumpers or like, 5 minute like filler slots or whatever. Yeah. It just doesn't.
Yeah.
You know?
Anyway, give me the second season of Pooey Pooey Mole Car, because I'm just
I want
oh my gosh. I did not watch that one. Was it worth the watch?
Yes. Oh, watch my the first gosh. Season on Netflix.
I should.
Like there's like almost no like actual dialogue in any of it. It's just watching felt little guinea pig cars smash into each other and
okay. Next suggestion for a TikTok list for us, by the way. If y'all don't follow us on TikTok, go do it. But we should do shorts that you have to watch. That's a good one.
That is a good one.
Because I've only watched Banania, and then I'm trying to think of, there's definitely another one that I've watched, but I can't think of it.
There's
a couple
of them when they were like, there was this show, not to get too far off topic, but there's this show that I watched quite a few years ago at this point. This would have been over 6 or so years ago, called was it Yumihiro Patisserie or Patisserie something? It was about
someone just mentioned that in the chat.
Oh, they did. Yeah. That one was good. Funny. It had like melodrama and plot, and it was cute.
Okay, we gotta do that list.
All right. Oh yeah, Skullface Bookseller Honda-san is another
Skullface
one.
Bookseller Honda-san is peak. That's
okay, so we've already just listed like three on that list. So
there you go.
You also got to put Senyu on there. That one's fun.
Is that Egg One that just dropped on Netflix? Is that a short?
The Gudetama one?
Yeah, there's a Gudetama anime.
Oh,
what?
There is.
You didn't know? It looks incredible too. Yeah,
it's on Netflix.
It's on Netflix, right?
Isn't it live action?
Jeff's mind blown.
So this next one is horny, and it's by the same guy that did Tulaparoo.
Oh, no.
So there's two.
The man knows he's horny.
That sounds like my kind of. He makes good horny.
Let's see what happens when he mixes monsters with horny.
Hey. Okay.
Is the volume okay on this, or do you guys want me to turn it up?
I'm okay. It doesn't sound like it has good music.
Oh no man, that's some rough.
Not gonna lie.
Though.
Yeah, it doesn't look great.
Yeah. I like the main character's outfit.
Yeah, it's cool.
And that cat.
There's a cat.
Oh my gosh, the cat's face is really cute. Oh my gosh, the cat. Oh no. Oh no. And then it got horny, as to be expected.
Of course.
Oh, no. Bad cat. Very bad cat.
Can't believe they faked me out with a cat.
They faked me out. They almost got me hooked with the cat. Yeah. That was cruel. That was not okay.
But then they go for, in Soviet Russia, pussy is you. Yeah.
No.
I was about to say, there's an alarming lack of boobs in this trailer, to be honest.
Yeah, it's not.
Everybody... get the X up. No.
Love and be loved, eat and... Did I say and be eaten?
No. How dare they trick us with the cat?
Is this going to be like a Vor anime? Is that
what this is? Oh, I don't know. I don't know what's happening.
No.
I'm going to have to X based on the trailer. Like, yeah. I feel like, To Love Rue Rider, and there's got to be some good horny stuff in there, but none of it showed up in the trailer. What the hell? It was all just bad action scenes.
Yeah, that was... The cat was cute.
The The cat for, was cute until he wasn't. Like,
exactly. The cat was cute until he wasn't. That is so true. Like, I was like, never mind. Okay, we're good now. We're good.
I'm gonna call the Humane Society. This is not a good cat. Oh, not a good cat.
Yeah. Moving on. Next.
Yeah. Oh, and as a correction, I guess it's by the artist, but not the author.
Oh, okay. That
so that
maybe,
might have
maybe it won't maybe it. It won't be as good at the horny, or maybe it'll. But I mean, so like it theoretically, that would mean it would be just as good at the horny. But then they're clearly not putting any significant effort into adapting the art. So
maybe they're saving it for a Red Band trailer.
Yeah, yeah, maybe all the good animation is titties. You're right. That would be in character.
Yeah,
they're just saying the 3 seconds of titties that we saw, there were some frames. So
that's correct. There were some frames.
It wasn't on ones, but it was, you know, it was like maybe on like
those were the, you know? I know, but it was like the anime like Jell-O stuffed into two balloons.
It did look like someone dumped a bunch of cottage cheese into a couple of socks and then stapled them onto the chest of a human being. But that is an aesthetic that people are, you know, I guess into.
Nick is here to let us know that the manga was horny enough that it got moved out of the Shonen Jump print magazine. So.
Okay, so was it a jump plus?
That says a lot because Shonen Jump printed almost bare boobs. You had to hold. There was a.
Are you talking about the tapioca pudding thing?
Yeah. So there was haunted Eunice Haunted Hot Springs.
Yeah,
there was a page where on the back they had like this red printed art of like tapioca pudding floating in water, and it didn't really make sense. But if you hold it up to the light, two red dots of tapioca pudding exactly line up with the space where the nipples should be on the censored boobs.
Guys, so that's actually perfect. That's actually one of the greatest things I've ever heard in my life.
It's
it really happened. We wrote an article about it.
That's incredible. That
mad
is absolutely
respect
incredible.
To the Shonen Jump editors, honestly. Like
that sounds like one of the editors was like, just like two weeks away from getting shit canned and was like, you know what? I've had this idea in my back pocket for 10 years. We're going to do it.
Seriously, though, that's too funny. All right, next one.
This next
I
one
only
is...
have I only have the Fire Hunter and Adventures on my list. It's been an hour.
I have Campfire Cooking on mine as well, but otherwise it's the same.
That's me too.
This one I'm curious about. It's an original project. I believe there's action in it and also people in fancy suits, and it's poker themed. This is High Card.
Did you say you were furious or curious?
Curious.
Okay.
Ooh, those are not very good cars.
Yeah, bad animation off the top.
I
don't really know that. Do not play cards and drive, people. That is just not acceptable at all.
I don't really love how cards is italicized and capitalized. That gives me...
Do you throw marbles in there? Are those like danger marbles? Oh, another thing about this is that it was somewhat inspired by Kingsman.
Mm. Oh, I do like Kingsman. I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah, those movies fuck.
Yeah, I like
them.
Or
at least the first one does.
The first one was really good. Yeah,
the third one looked cool. The prequel.
I haven't seen.
They were like entertaining enough.
Yeah. Olivia got fire hands.
So this has nothing to do with poker, really.
I was like, what has been poker related? He carried a card while driving.
They get like card powers. Is this like Taboo Tattoo but with playing cards? Because I don't
know. Hell yeah, it is. I'm warming up to those cars. I still think the shaders on them look kind of bad, but like
they don't blend well with the background. But they
the Klondike but they, Mafia, you guys.
The level of shininess kind of fits the like.
Yeah.
It's not Art Deco, but you know they're kind of like get going for that vibe with the aesthetic. Yeah, I don't know how to put it.
This actually looks. You know what?
It looks good, right?
I'm not gonna lie, there are parts of this that are kind of genius. The cars were really bad in the beginning, though. I agree with Jeff. I was like, what is going on? I'm a sucker for a guy. I'm a sucker for a guy with eyeliner, and there was a redheaded guy with eyeliner for sure. And
there was at least two dudes with eyeliner.
Yeah. Or it was like the shading around the eyes were just like perfect.
Someone, Miss LG Taylor says it's the same writer as Kakiguri, and it did give me.
Easy. That 100%. It's funny. I actually thought that for a second, but then I just didn't say it out loud. I was like, oh, kind of reminds me of Kakiguri. What was the name of that one? I'll write it down.
High card with a backwards D. You got to get that right.
So it's like a B? Yeah. So it's high carb? So it's just like a high carb diet?
No, backwards uppercase D.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's you can't write that title anyway but all caps.
Yeah.
Okay. I just changed it to an uppercase backwards D. Thank you for clarifying. But yes. Next.
Okay, this next one also has scary Japanese monsters in it. It's based off a manga. This is called Malevolent Spirits: Mononogatari. So let's but not just me. It's got some music drops.
Yeah. It's got some
spirits that possess old objects. Okay.
Show me some action. Show me some blood.
Oh, that guy's
massive.
That guy looks like everything taken from him.
Not super sold on the visual.
Yeah, I'm not loving it. That was cool looking.
It's like there's some decent design elements going on, but I don't know if the execution is that great.
Yeah, well, whenever
anything has
right.
to resort to flipping to like the negative color schemes to like make it look spooky, I get a little suspect.
I mean, actually, like the colors are, I would say, the only part of this that's working, and like the only reason that I think anybody's saying like, oh, saying anything other than this looks like crap, because like the line art's terrible.
Yeah, just
consistently terrible. But like,
they all look like
whoever did the color design for this. Whoever did the color design for this did a really good job. Like the backgrounds and everything, like blend
not
with the
vibing.
Characters well. But it's just not. It's not.
I'm
good
not
materials.
Vibing with this at
there,
all.
There are a couple of decent cuts in there, but yeah, it does not look consistent at all.
Yeah.
It looks like if you were in the middle of like a 50 episode like shonen anime run.
Yeah.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Totally. Yes. That was a good comparison.
Yeah.
Yeah, it looks like one of those Naruto episodes where, like, literally half of it's just a flashback.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's
I like that title card. That's kind of neat, I guess.
Yeah.
That's something.
Yeah, that was. If people wanted to understand more of the plot, like, there's the guy, he's from a clan that exercises cursed objects that turn into monsters, and then he starts living with the girl who lives with a bunch of those same kinds of monsters. But yeah, just looked really mid as a kid.
Very exceptionally mid. Like nothing stuck out to me from that.
Yeah.
I'm good.
Yeah.
Very good.
Okay, this one I'm curious about only because it actually stars a girl. It's an isekai. Ooh. Well, not an isekai. It's not an isekai, but it is a reincarnation story. This is reborn to master the blade, from hero king to extraordinary squire.
Okay.
Hero King Inglis's last wish, I'm assuming that's him there, was to live again as a warrior. Though when he awakens, he realizes he's been reborn as a girl to a noble
family. Oh, so it's
family.
A gender swap reborn.
Mm.
Yeah.
Okay.
Even when rejected from the knighthood, she sets out to be the most extraordinary squire there ever was. So that must be baby King Inglis as a girl with his new mom and dad.
Okay.
She's cute. Oh, I think she's adorable.
Mm.
I'm a sucker for white hair and red eyes. I'm a sucker for it.
Definitely a potent combo. The background.
No, not the little fairy girl through the boobs. I actually thought that was funny.
Yeah.
But I usually don't like that shit.
I hope the show doesn't spend like a whole bunch of time on when she's like a little kid.
Yeah.
But This looks all right.
I'm actually vibing. Yeah,
cute girlfriends too.
Right? I love all the girls. I love them. A maid with a bow and arrow.
Done.
I am a sucker for
whenever they're at like a super swanky like aristocrat party, but then they got to throw down. Like I've always,
it's
my favorite trope. Yeah,
there's cosplays for days in this show.
Yeah.
You know which show I didn't love, but just aesthetically I appreciated so much? It was the one with the vampire. No, not the vampire. What Vanitas? Were they? It was the guy and he had dark hair and blue eyes and they were really pretty and it was like
the Vanitas.
Vanitas? Okay, Case study of Vanitas. Yeah. I love the aesthetics of that, but I fell
show
off
whips
of
ass.
It.
What was that
Does it,
last one
does it
called?
So yeah. good?
It's yes. really good. It's really, really good.
It fell off for me. I got bored. I get bored easily, though.
I'm writing that one down. Reborn to master the blade. Got the power of God and anime on my side.
that looked solid. I was actually vibing with that. So when it was the old man turning into a girl, I was kind of like, oh, is this going to be weird? I just got like a weird feeling. Like I just didn't know how they were going to go with it, you know? Yeah. But then it actually looked like when she got older that, you know, it wasn't weird or perverted or like anything super strange was going on. So I was like, oh, okay. So
yeah.
Because
I've seen that exact anime.
Exactly.
She professed herself pupil of the wise man. About a very powerful wizard in a VR MMO who gets trapped in the VR MMO in the body of a little girl that he was just trying out because he got it as a gift item, but then he got stuck in it. What a awful thing that happened. And then he's got to pee all the time, and they call like a lot of attention to how much he's got to pee.
What was that show about the guy who got reborn as like a girl, and then his office colleague is like in love with him.
Oh, Nick reviewed that. That's I know
Bombshell or something like that.
Yeah.
Reincarnated as a that one's fun. That one's really fun.
Yeah,
that one's like
that one didn't seem to get too weird.
Two bros who really don't want to admit that they want to fuck each other.
Yeah, and then one of them's turned into a girl. Yeah.
How funny!
All right, this next one. This is number 20. Vampire Dies in No Time, season 2.
Ooh, vampires.
Which was a cute comedy.
That was funny.
I
think that's one that I would have preferred if it were like a short.
I agree with that.
But I've also been on a huge Castlevania kick, and so...
Castlevania's fun.
Yeah.
Castlevania season 1 was fun. Season 2 was all right. One of the seasons fell off, and the
season
like,
3 was
like,
awful. But season
4
was
3 great, was so. Terrible, yeah. Not good. Anyway, season sorry, I'm focusing.
What
in the phallic hell was that?
Vampire, probably.
That was some made in abyss creature going on right there. Like
this God, I legit love this show's world. Like, if you're not familiar with The Vampire Dies in No Time, it's set in a world where vampires are basically, like, low-level pests that people have to deal with.
Like a cockroach?
Yeah. So, like, the main character is a famous vampire hunter, and he lives with a vampire after destroying his house. But...
No, not the armadillo.
Yeah, the armadillo's so good. Yeah, this
his name just like John or something really plain.
It is. John. This show's
obviously
got a really strong sense of
it's kind
of
making fun of Trigun too, isn't it? From the outfit. I was assuming the red, all red. I don't know. Maybe it's not. It seems to be kind of making fun of like the 90s anime that we all you know, all the vampire anime and wild stuff like that. So that's kind of cool.
The opening last season was really good. It had like
it was so catchy.
Opening.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Next one is another season 2. This is by The Grace of the Gods, which was kind of an Iyashike, like kid befriends a whole bunch of slimes and can then do things with them.
Mm-hmm. There were like four of those last season. I can't remember.
Right.
Is this where they had a bunch of them?
Yeah. There's been quite a few slime shows now.
It's part of a genre I like to call Karo Shisekai. The character works himself to death. And yeah. then he gets to live in Dragon Quest as his reward.
Yeah. Where he just does simple things like the laundry with slimes and the dishes with slimes and builds a house with slimes.
I will say, having finally started playing the Dragon Quest games this year, I get it more than I did before. Yeah. But I still, of all the RPG universes to be reincarnated into, I'm still not entirely sure why.
Dude, should have been Chrono Trigger. Though I heard that, no, actually that's not true. Someone's making an indie game that's supposed to be kind of like Chrono Trigger-esque. But yeah, I don't know. Dragon Quest is cool though.
Yeah,
but now, there's so many JRPGs from when we were kids that are so much better, in my opinion. Fox Girl is super cool.
Yeah.
She's cool. I like her hair.
Like I used to come down on Drakwe for being too basic, but like I've played more of it now and I
they're fun. Really, they're really
appreciate what those games do. Like they're like, I mean, they're, it makes sense that they'd be the video game equivalent of Dragon Ball, but they're like just that pure fairy tale quality of fantasy adventure where like it's nothing special necessarily, but it's just good.
Well, something I've noticed with the Dragon Quest games that I've played, I've been playing 7 on the 3DS, I played through some of 4 and I played through the first 3. And something that Dragon Quest has, and maybe it's a localization thing that a lot of these isekai don't, is that even when you go to like whatever random village in like Dragon Quest 7, each of them has its own really strong sense of character. So like, you know, even if it's as simple as like, this is the village where everyone talks with like a thick Cockney accent, and this is the village where everyone talks with a thick, you know, Spanish accent. Names, but like, sorry, you still have that. Like,
you can't go thick Cockney accent and like pause there. I was really concerned.
Like, everybody talks like, with what? Their thick cocks. It's just coming out of the...
It was so weird. It's such a kid-friendly game, and then they just start slapping them on the table, and I was like... Hey.
Oh my God. What is happening?
Can we all just...
Did we even watch that trailer? No, all we did was talking about Dragon Quest and like everything else.
I mean, it's... Yeah. You know, it's kind of...
Yeah, it didn't catch my attention either.
It was a lot of flappy mouths. And slimes, and then I mean, hey, I hear the show's like really wholesome, and
it is. If you ignore the fact that the main character is like a 30-year-old man with a love interest who's 8,
because he's in like an 8-year-old.
He's been reincarnated into an 8-year-old's body, but
it doesn't make it better anime. It doesn't fix.
I know why anime. Why?
That's just one of those things that you. In that genre, you just kind of gotta.
I kind of want to get a shirt that says "Why anime? Why?" But then I thought, then I think people will be like,
"What are you?
She doesn't like anime." And then I'll be like, "No, I do. I love anime." But
no, the problem is you just gotta say why. And you watch as much as we do.
Exactly. Why anime? Why? Like the cat. Amazing character, super cute, and then like they reel us in, and then it has to say some weird horny comment, and you're just like, why anime?
Why? Yeah. It's just like it's super cute, super mascot. I'm so kawaii, nya. I want to eat that girl's entire asshole, nya.
You see, but then you get to the point where you're like me and you're watching Made in Abyss and it's like, this is great. And then you want to recommend it to your loved ones. But then thankfully, a voice in your head stops you and says,
I will tell you, there is nothing in this world funnier than the normie 1-star reviews on Amazon.com of Made in Abyss.
Oh,
it was available for streaming on Amazon Prime, right?
Yeah. So yeah.
Well, it was on Anime Strike. When that was a thing.
But like, so there's just like normal people who have Amazon Prime because they have Amazon Prime who watched that show and thought that it was a show to watch with their kids.
Oh my gosh.
It is for like a few episodes, maybe. Like, you know.
No, I think the pee stuff starts pretty early in there. You don't.
Well, in the first episode, she does shove a stick into Reg's butthole. But it's
she's hung from the ceiling naked. Beaten with a swatch.
That as well. Yep. Yep. That's Made in Abyss, everybody.
That is Made in Abyss.
One of the greatest and most like emotionally resonant fantasy stories ever written in anime.
Yep.
For
yep.
real.
Yeah. No,
just, you know what's that, so that's funny?
That's what sucks about it. It's so good that it's like, if more people knew this story, the world would probably be a better place, but there'd also be a lot more lists. And we can't.
Yeah.
We gotta
It's
like, come on, man. No.
All right, guys.
Yeah. We're going into... talk about Made in Abyss forever. I'm like, moving on.
We're going into another isekai. I swear it's the last one for, I don't know, a little bit.
Like this 5 minutes.
This one, the dude who's isekai used to work as a handyman. And we're going to see how that works out.
DIY isekai.
I know. I'm like, okay, like, let me hear more.
I do like, so one of my favorite isekai tropes that doesn't get exploited enough is when it's not a, like a cheesy video game world, but it's actually supposed to be like medieval times, and they use their knowledge of future technology to like, you know, impress people and like do cool stuff.
Like that kid with a smartphone, James? Into the world with my smartphone?
I think
my brain short-circuited for a second. I can't remember if I actually watched that. But, you know, like that, but good. Like, you know.
Mm. Ascendance of a Bookworm.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like that one.
I really like the character designs in this. They're strong. Yeah,
I have no idea what's going on in this trailer, though.
Yeah, I don't know either.
It kind of dropped us in.
That guy's really funny.
Was that a video Crystal game? Ball live stream?
It appeared to be, yeah. I can't really comment one way or another about that because I don't know what I just watched. I'm not even entirely sure who the main character was.
Like the dude in Popeye that asks for hamburgers. He's fun.
Oh my gosh. It did look like a Popeye character. Oh, yeah. I didn't know what was going on though. I was like,
I'll gladly pay you Sunday for a slave harem today.
James, stop.
I think that one looked pretty good though. Like overall, like
I just
like,
couldn't tell what it was about.
Me neither.
Yeah, I was like,
I didn't see any handymaning. You know, I didn't see.
Yeah, I was like, I wanted him to like build some rafters or like.
Yeah, this or is build a guillotine. Something.
Here's
build
how we can
thing.
Get rid of people. I don't know, like.
Whoa, James! Always.
So I was just listening to a podcast of the French Revolution. That was a really revolutionary, no pun intended, device. I was.
Did you just say guillotine or did I just imagine that? Okay.
Yeah.
James and I are on the same wavelength because I didn't know what he was talking about, but then I saw Jackie's reaction and was like, he must have said guillotine.
Well, now I'm just thinking about why the guillotine is actually like probably really state of the art for its time, and it helped reduce suffering of people getting executed. And exactly. I'm like, why is my mind here? Because of James. Imagine, why am I even thinking this?
Executing common criminals in another world. That could be a show where it's like, how do I make the
Why am I thinking this? Why are we here, James?
The guillotine is not a device for common criminals. It is a device for the most uncommon of criminals who rule over all of us. That is who the guillotine is for. Do not forget it.
Would you say that there's maybe only like 1% of them that need to, in the general population that need to be?
What are we advocating for right now during this stream, guys? What are we doing?
Fun anime. That you
I don't anime. Even know. I'm
we're,
lost.
We're again. Advocating for playing Minecraft at Elon Musk's house.
Oh or, my goodness!
We can Lynzee, kill him in golf. All right. So
how far are we?
We are at number 23. We're gonna hit 25, and then we're gonna do a short intermission for refills.
So we're close to halfway. Okay.
Yeah, we're close to halfway.
Yeah. I'm only have four on my list.
I have five, but those could be cut as we move further down, I guess.
Oh, no, yeah. I have two because I only wrote down Egyptian god so I could get my wife a good plushie. So
that's right.
Those characters were cute, but okay.
Yeah. All right, so this next one, it was delayed several times. This is Inspector season two.
Now, did this one fall off really hard? That was my impression of it.
It didn't fall off so much as it just dragged out a lot.
I loved the first like three episodes or so of this one.
Yeah, it just kind of devolved into like the mystery solving got a little too slow, and they spent a little too much time sitting around talking as opposed to doing all the stuff that was good in the first half.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Cute kitty.
Yeah. Can we trust
this? It's a great premise. I mean, this is just
really great makeup.
Sure. Yeah. Ugh. Like, yeah, the animation, everything in this looks, it looks really good. I didn't watch the first season, though.
Oh my god, the bunny. Okay, I don't know what this is about, but I'm loving what I'm seeing.
It's about this guy who's...
She's gorgeous, by the way.
Yeah, so he's got, like, a special magical body that Beckett's explained in it. And this girl
is
like a bridge between the spirit slash monster and human worlds. And she falls in love with him, and there's a whole bunch of stuff. It's good. It's got like good like character drama and stuff.
Whoa! Did that kid just try to kiss an adult man?
No, they're the same age.
They're the same age.
Okay, she's his
girlfriend.
Yeah.
Oh, y'all! I almost thought it was a Y anime Y moment for a second. Yeah. Okay. We're okay. Okay.
No, this isn't. No, this isn't that weird butler anime. I think going on still. So.
Butler anime.
Yeah, or the maiden. Yeah. The maid that's trying to seduce her 10-year-old ward.
The Duke and his maid,
something like that. I just
there's a couple of these.
Yes, but But no, this is on the level, Jacki. This one's on the level, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. This next one has, as far as I can tell, no magic, no fantasy whatsoever. It's about girls playing judo.
Ooh. I mean, Judo's cool.
Cute.
Yeah.
Is the animation going to be good enough to make the judo worth watching? That's the question.
Looks
like the CGI doesn't look.
Yeah,
that good.
I actually didn't think that was awful. We got to see more.
Yeah.
The girls are cute.
I like how round they are. I like the roundness.
Yeah. They look like real, like little girls.
This is called a Ippon Again, and it's going to stream on High Dive.
They're cute.
What?
I don't know why. The animation is rough, though.
Yeah.
Why anime? Why?
I feel like everything that's not a judo scene is going to be barely animated at all.
Yeah.
That's what I mean. I'm like, where's the judo? Show me the judo. Show me the action.
Yeah.
There we go.
All right, we're getting there.
Oh, here we go. All right, that's
something.
That was terrible.
Wait.
That was all right. I mean, I guess.
When you're watching a judo anime and you go, "That was all right" for the animated scene, that's a bad sign.
Yeah, there's no impact to any of this.
I know. It looks like they're doing a lot of those, like, the still shots.
Speed
the
lines.
Yeah. That's a good sign. Oh, but they seem nice. Like, I want them
to
succeed.
They're cute. The girls are cute. There was that weird spank thing, but besides that, you know.
Yeah.
I won't be watching it.
Yeah, probably not for me either. But it did look cute. Inoffensive might be a nice way to spend some time. I don't know. But
if you're like a martial arts enthusiast, I'm sure it could
maybe
be like
Yeah.
I never. It's always weird because a lot of these, like, girls doing a really
Caitlin Moore just said, Caitlin Moore just said, gee, damn it. Wait, can we get a girl sports anime that's actually well animated?
I know,
and it's
right?
Like, truth.
Yeah,
that's there is one.
Which one?
Actually, two.
Oh,
Hanebato is fucking amazing, right?
That's volleyball, right?
No, Hanebato is badminton.
Oh, yes. Badminton, mm-hmm.
Oh. And then Harukana Receive, which is beach volleyball, and I don't need to explain why that's why.
Dude, I need to watch that anime. Oh, well, is it just
Wait, Jacki, you haven't seen that?
No, it's also
I play beach volleyball, like, all the time.
Yeah.
What's it called?
Harukana Receive. On Keijo. Keijo is, like, the best animated sports anime ever.
Okay. Well, then maybe we were mistaken, but that one's not going to be.
No, we're not. Keijo is about knocking other girls off.
Keijo is good. That show is.
It is good, but it's about wearing bathing suits and attacking girls with your butts. So
it's
the girls
sport of queens.
You're trying to, like, a floating platform in a pool, and you put the circular, kind of like sumo.
Exactly what it is.
But you're only allowed to make contact with your butt.
Boobs.
Now, Geoff, correct me if I'm wrong, but isn't there a special move in Keijo that is basically the Fate Stay Night summons, but with boobs?
Yeah, oh, there's tons of them. There's like like an ass mirage where there's like a thousand asses all coming at you from a different angle. Keijo, it's amazing.
Birdie Wing, that's a great anime.
Birdie Wing.
Worst anime ever. Worst anime ever. I hate Birdie Wing.
Jacki, I've lost control.
I hate Birdie Wing. We're done with this conversation.
How can you hate Birdie Wing?
Birdie Wing, okay. What
We're
if
not
we're
doing
so,
this.
Birdie Wing is not. Yeah, we can't. We can't. I will just go off.
This will become like a whole other thing.
It's like Birdie Wing doesn't do what Akiba Maid War does. It doesn't go hard enough. Like, it's like, we're going to do the colors and we're going to do a mafia. But like, it just doesn't go hard enough. Like, Akiba Maid
War doesn't go hard enough when the mafia cyborg golfs so hard her arm breaks,
but
then she has to be killed for not golfing hard enough.
It's like, I don't know, with Akiba Maid War, I just felt like it was so campy and so extreme and it's so violent and so like dark that it like worked. And I felt like Birdie Wing didn't go like dark enough or hard enough for me. That cyborg arm thing is pretty fucked up though. So I'm like, okay, but that was pretty dark. But I don't know. I was like, it just seems stupid to me. Thank you. Someone else said Birdie Wing is so stupid. And that's what makes
stupid.
It good.
It's,
no, Caitlin, it's no. So no,
it's
Caitlin, I thought you were on my team.
It's a Beyblade or a Yu-Gi-Oh, but with golf. Jacki, and that's just
terrible. I hate Birdie Wing. I don't care.
Okay.
We're
at trailer 25. If anyone needs to go like take a short Birdie Wing walk to get their Birdie Wing feelings out, now's the time to do it.
Me.
Okay.
Where's a golf club when you need it? No, I'm kidding.
All right.
I don't know. Sorry. But if you want to talk about a good anime, Gungrave, everybody. You should watch Gungrave.
I knew it was happening. The minute she said it.
On Lindsay and James's faces.
Good time.
Sorry, Geoff, I'm obsessed with Gungrave. I have this weird obsession. And it's not weird. It's amazing.
I can't say I remember anything about that anime, but
Does this mean no one needs a bathroom break? Yeah, we'll take a break. Yes. We'll be back.
Children, go take your break.
All right. And all right. You guys,
how long's
go to
the break?
Bathroom
like a minute?
And have a drink, maybe. Have
I'm going to give you like 2 minutes.
Okay. We'll be back.
Okay. We'll be back.
All right. I'll just stay here, you know. How's everybody doing? You all having a good time? Get in the comments. Do you guys think I can set up Boji in 2.5 minutes? I got him for my husband for Christmas. I think he needs his little cape. I had to decapitate him, though, to put his cape on. And then... he's got a tiny sword. How does he hold this? Oh, I have to change his hands out. Do you want to remember if Boji is left or right-handed?
I'm back.
I'm trying to put together a tiny Boji.
A tiny Boji? Tiny Boji.
Tiny Boji.
Oh, he's so cute. I want to cry just looking at him.
I'm back, everybody.
Welcome back.
Okay, so I want to hear from chat. Which ones are you vibing with right now? Which ones are you picking? I have the Fire Hunter, Adventurers, High Card, and Reborn for me. But what are y'all picking?
Those are all solid picks. Right now I'm putting together a tiny Boji.
Oh my god, what the hell is that?
It's
so,
so
cute.
I know. It's the cutest.
Guys, Boji could arguably be one of the cutest anime characters of all time.
Agree.
I don't even know if it's arguable. Like, if you said he's not, I would probably just have to tell you that you're wrong.
Like who else is in that top five list, though?
If someone came up to me and started talking trash about Boji, I mean, I feel like legally, I'd have to slap him in the mouth.
Right. Yeah, you can't talk shit on Boji. That's not acceptable ever.
Someone was talking shit on Boji?
No, we're saying Anya is up there. I'm sorry though, Anya fans. I think Boji just edges out Anya a little bit.
I think he's
cuter
than Anya too.
Yeah, I'm sorry. And
why are we having this argument? It's been such a good year for little guys who go around. Can we not just enjoy all the different little guys going around?
What I'm going to do is I'm going to write my Boji goes to Anya's school fanfic. And she becomes best friends with him.
Oh my God.
She learns sign language because all the other rich kids are bullying him, but Anya learns sign language and she can read his mind. And oh my God, you guys, she could read his mind. Can you imagine the...
Oh my gosh, stop. Can you write this fanfic? Actually,
I have my fanfiction account open right now. We're going to do it.
I'm here for it.
All right. We all ready? Is everyone back? Do you all got your
I got snacks? I refilled my smoothie.
Okay. Did you run the blender back there while you did it?
I did not run the blender. Because Yazzie got us boba.
Aww.
Is it a fruit boba? Is it a sweet boba?
Fruit boba. Peach with, I think... lime or green melon pearls. Good.
Nice.
That sounds good.
All right.
Wait, no, sorry. Green apple pearls. It's green apple. Oh, okay. Peach and green apple.
Do they taste like a Jolly Rancher? Is it that green
apple? But like a liquid one that just like...
I haven't messed with the kind of Gusher pearls.
They're so good. They're so, you definitely highly recommend a Gusher boba.
I've gotten some with... oh my gosh, the Filipino, the Halo Halo.
How many trailers are left?
Half of them.
Yeah.
We have 25.
We're about to watch number 25. There's a total of 55. We are only halfway done. So if anyone was keeping track.
Let's
try and go a little faster, I guess. This is
so why don't we start off talking about this great little anime called Gungrave? No, I'm kidding.
Jacki, I'm gonna need you.
We won't bring up Gungrave anymore. Okay. We need to do this more. It is a lie. But we need to do this more, you guys, so then we get out of a trailer faster. There were so many bad ones.
Well, a lot of them are only like 30 seconds long.
That's
but
true.
But some of them weren't. You guys are talking about Dragon Quest for like a whole 3-minute trailer. And I was like,
it's a culturally important anime and far more interest or game and far more interesting than anything.
It was far more interesting than that trailer, but okay.
This next trailer is 2 minutes. So I guess if you want to, you know, give it them
more, prepare the X. Yes.
Prepare for that. This is, the Tale of Outcasts. Oh no.
Okay. The music right now. The music was like the most dramatic, and I kind of loved it. I'm not gonna lie.
Oh, it's got furry.
Hey,
is this one of those? Is this adapted from an Otome game?
It's not adapted from an Otome game, but this girl here is Wisteria, and she's an orphan living in the British Empire and at the 19th century. Her life is desolate and bleak until she encounters Marbus, a powerful but equally lonely immortal being with a furry appearance who's hounded by hunters.
Is this just like even hornier Grimoire of Zero? Is that what we're watching?
Well, yeah, because Grimoire of Zero just had like a polar bear in it.
Okay,
also Ancient Mage's Bride, though.
I kind of like this.
Yeah, that's cool.
I would like it more if it was animated better.
And a wolf boy too?
This is for some people.
Yeah, it is for some people.
Oh no. Dude's got a scythe. Sign me up. Scythe was always my favorite weapon. The first time I played D&D, I used a scythe.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Very Soul Eater-esque of you.
Yeah. I hope that girl does more stuff than cry, though, because we've sure seen a lot of her crying. Whoa,
I think that was the wolf guy with the spikes on his head.
The furry prince, he's got an inconsistent muzzle, and it's bothering me.
I'm not gonna lie, I didn't hate that one.
Yeah,
I kind of want to write it down. So I'm going to.
Okay. I mean, the like the world seems interesting. I'm just like not sold on the animation.
The animation wasn't great. I kind of like the characters though, and I'm like intrigued by that world.
Yeah.
It's for some people, as Lindsay said. Nobody laughed at that joke. And I laughed.
Thanks for pointing out that no one laughed at it.
Nobody heartily laughed at it. Everyone was like, nice.
You want us to do the Titus laughs from Final Fantasy X? Is that what we need?
Yeah,
every time.
Titus laughs.
Okay, next time we'll
just have that on the soundboard. Come on,
James. I need it for my self-esteem. Personally, so
okay. Everyone's like, Jackie's a furry sympathizer. You know what? Beastars is good. Don't at me, okay? And I've always been a wolf girl. I love Wolf's Reign. Like, I don't know. The wolf boy, and I was sold. Stop it, Lindsay. I just threw my pen.
People are gonna start saying Omegaverse stuff about you. That's what you just opened up.
God. I am kicking my legs happily under this desk right now. Okay, so. This next one has it's a rom-com. The Angel Next Door spoils me rotten. So let's just try and figure this out. If it doesn't have subtitles, I'll tell you more about the plot. Okay, it doesn't have subtitles. All right. So Amane lives alone in an apartment. The most beautiful girl in school, my hero. Kind of questionable about that claim, by the way. This character doesn't look that beautiful to me, but whatever. She lives just next door.
She looks like she's gonna die from some incurable disease. I'm calling it now.
Looks exactly like an anime version. Like when she's not beautiful, she's like extremely plain. She's like the anime version of Egg. No, sorry, Anne from Arrested Development. You know, the girl that George Michael dates, who everybody's like, her?
You guys are being so mean to her.
I know. I'm like, this girl is not that horrible.
It's just like the most boring character. I mean,
she looks like she maybe needs to condition more. Her hair's looking a little
okay.
Look, she got sick.
I'm telling you, Bonitis.
Taking care of her in the bed. Mm-hmm. He gives her a teddy bear. So yeah, it's a romantic comedy between two high schoolers who live in apartments next door to each other.
Oh wow, never seen that before.
Yeah.
Wait, are they gonna actually smooch though? Because that's usually like what they can never decide if they're gonna have them do or not. Like,
meanwhile, Hori Mia goes all the way.
Yeah. Oh, and then some. Yeah. Mm. Yeah. Yeah. So anyway, that was the Angel Next Door spoils me rotten. All right.
I'm with Tomi now. I need more of these kids to just be groping on each other. That's what we're gonna do. Like, just commit to the bit.
This is gonna be taken completely out of context.
That's
James.
Gonna be taken.
Great. Did it to yourself. All right.
Thanks, Tomino.
If you're listening to this in a TikTok out of context later, I do not endorse that message.
Oh my, James, you're in trouble.
I'm just saying.
All right.
Moving on.
This next one doesn't have children in it, at least not to my knowledge. It is an isekai call, or it's just a fantasy. I don't know. This is chilling in my 30s after getting fired from the Demon King's army.
Name of the anime?
That's the whole name of the whole anime.
I'm liking the respect that people in their 30s have been getting in anime lately. That's, you know. It's good to be recognized.
Now, I've seen the key art of this, and this is the plainest looking dude. The most potato dude.
Oh, you weren't kidding.
Just completely really? Nondescript looking guy. But hey, you know, he teams up with a lady with big titties, so let's go.
Homeboy looks like he spends a lot of his time on Twitter complaining about how Avatar hasn't made a cultural impact in the last decade. That's like his identity.
Man, those are huge.
Like her boobs.
100%. He was talking about her like, boobs.
Yeah, yeah. The whole tavern wench design. We don't have enough of those in anime.
Please look at this dude's face. And do you believe he could do anything confidently?
Oh, he's
doing 30-year-olds dirty. All right, like he looks fucking like that.
He looks exactly like not Ryuho Okawa from the fifth. Or maybe fourth Happy Science movie. The one where he's fighting a
snake. Yeah!
by the way, someone wrote, Salty Oven wrote, he's staring right at them. There was literally a scene where he was like on his knees, just like staring right at her boobs. And I was like, this is weird. Why anime? Why? We need to make this a shirt. We got to talk to our boss, Lynzee, and see if we can get that shirt made. Why anime? Why?
Why?
All right. I'm not watching that one. No, thank you.
No, that's all right. I'm okay without thinking about that ever again.
I'm the only one utilizing the X. Okay.
This next one is a sequel about that girl who teases that guy, but they really like each other. No, not that one. It's the other one. Don't toy with me.
You mean not? It's not the good one.
It's Don't Toy With Me, Miss Nagataro.
That is the good one.
Oh,
that,
now
it's a good one.
Now we're gonna fight.
So I'm just bitter that more people haven't recognized Teasing Master Takagi-san for the masterpiece that
that's
it is.
Takagi-san's better, I would say, like in terms of like comedy and stuff. But like, I don't know. This one's really cute.
Does it get cute?
I don't get this anime. I don't watch this anime. I don't know.
It's when you like being teased.
Yeah, so it's about a young nerd discovering that he really likes being stepped on. Like, a lot. Like, a lot. but a lot. No, it's like, actually sweet.
Was she in a bunny outfit? We can't just pretend that didn't just happen.
She was. What? She was sprinting in a Playboy bunny outfit, 100%.
Yeah, okay.
Nice.
That reminds me that Rascal Does Not Dream of Bunny Girl is going to get a new movie soon, and that's going to break my heart into pieces.
Aww. The animation in this is like a noticeable step down from the first season.
I was going to say, was it always this bad?
No. It was shinier last time.
Yeah. It was pretty for the first season. I actually do remember seeing the first season trailer and being like, this does not look like my thing, but it was so pretty. But
yeah, no, they had like a lot of really great shots, and just like, even if the animation wasn't incredible, they were really economical with it.
Hey, James, were you just talking about that?
Why?
Suddenly the animation quality shoots up for some reason.
Why anime? Why? I was gonna say we should put that on TikTok, but I think we would get banned, so we can't even put that on TikTok.
He just grubbed her boobie.
But I will say, like,
that it's consensual groping is.
Yeah, it's all consensual, and usually, like, when he ends up groping her, it's because she played chicken with him, and it's. It was. But
okay, next.
I want to take a sec just to say Nagatoro's like actually like legitimately a very sweet little, not deep but solid love story rom-com thing in manga form, and like there's actually some really good like subtle character stuff in there, and I don't know if that fully transfers to the anime, especially the second season, because that looked like crap, but
the production does look really weak, unfortunately.
All right, so this next one is also a sequel, but I heard good things about the first season of this. I still haven't watched it. This is The Misfit of Demon King Academy Dos.
This show's so good.
In the first season, in the first episode, he literally beats a guy to death multiple times using only his heartbeat.
It's incredible. The show is legitimately, I wish. This is one that I ended up having to marathon at the end of the season, because about halfway through I knew it was going to be one of my favorites.
The final boss fight of season one is literally against the CEO of racism. anti-demon, like human demon racism. But still, like the CEO.
Amos Voldigold.
They beat up racism for the finale. It's
what is this dude with a tiny hat? Do you see that?
Some kind of demon king, I think.
Dumb hat. What?
This show honestly brought me back to when I was like 14, 15, and I would just grab whatever the hell off of the library shelf and think it was the best show ever.
Oh, that's like, this is like
tiny hat.
By the way, that lineup of girls that we just saw, Lynzee, is his personal fan club / idol unit that sings theme songs for him while he is fighting.
Wow.
Yeah.
It's That show.
So are you guys just literally being serious?
No, this show is great. Jeff really like it.
This show is legitimately great.
Because yeah, I'm not gonna lie, it does look really good, but I couldn't tell if you guys were joking or not.
No,
yeah, so, no, the show is really good. So Anos Voldigode is like, it's another one of those, you know, all powerful demon king reincarnates
but it does
in
it
the modern
right.
day.
It actually, it's like fantasy One Punch Man, basically.
Punch Man is what I called it in my video because he literally kills a guy by beating his heart at him. And, like, he just beats his heart at him so much that he turns into pulp, and then he snaps his fingers and magically rearranges him to do it again and again and again until he gives up.
He also drops a castle on someone, right? Doesn't he, like, drop a castle
on someone? He basketball spins an entire castle on his finger and then throws it at somebody.
Yeah.
So is it a comedy or is it serious?
It's an action comedy. It's seriously funny. Okay. And like, yeah, so there's this whole thing about like how half demons are kind of discriminated against in the demon world. And he was reborn as a half demon, but he's all powerful. And like an anti-half demon racist teacher is bullying him for a while. So he gets back at her by killing her and then turning her into a half demon so that she has to experience the discrimination that she inflicted on others.
Oh, wow.
So
it's like intense as hell.
It's like, it's all over the place in terms of like,
yeah, I was like, that was intense.
No, it's legit.
And in the fight where he does that, his idol unit sings his theme song.
I think I'm gonna, after this call, maybe I'll just put that on my to watch list for like New Year's Eve, because I always marathon something on New Year's Eve. Maybe that'll be it.
It's very bingeable.
No matter how much intoxicant you have, it will still be fun, if not more fun.
All right, this next one is the reincarnation of the strongest exorcist in another world, and I feel like everything's in the title, but if you need more, why do I keep clicking that button? If you need more, I'll fill you in.
Was he an exorcist on Earth?
Yeah, he was a onmyoji in his world. And then he's reincarnated into another world. But this time he belongs to a family of wizards, but he doesn't have any magic ability. So he decides to use the onmyoji powers he has from his past life.
The visuals look all right.
Yeah. I saw Cyclops.
Yeah. I did.
There's two moons.
Got some atmosphere, it looks like. Trying to...
Background art looks nice. What was that guy? Was he also wearing a tiny hat?
I think it was a regular hat.
Was it a regular hat? All right.
So you look like a goat demon.
Lindsay, you are obsessed with the hat.
I am.
Tiny hat.
It was so stupid, that hat.
It was incredibly dumb. There's two moons.
Oh, all the reincarnation things
look really good.
Yeah,
that did look good.
These are some nice magic effects.
Yeah. This doesn't look bad. I mean, I couldn't tell you about the story, but...
Yeah.
The guy at the window just randomly looking out. That's why that was so funny to me.
He's just
staring. He's like... I'm dumb. I'm sorry. Some of these monsters are really cool.
Yeah. That cobra dude.
Oh, cool.
I mean, if it's gonna have like a twinge of like a horror theme to it, I think that's like a nice spin on
this song.
All these like pseudo fisheye shots are weird though.
Yeah, it's kind of hard to know what they're going for with just all these super quick cuts.
Yeah.
They're just like flexing all their cool monsters.
Yeah.
They are
really
fast.
Think of this like these like throat singing like
It's got mad style.
I
kind of
like the music. Yeah. I didn't hate it.
I didn't
love it though either. So I'm like, all right. Yeah.
Yeah, like the only thing that's really like drawing me to it is like the directing is like slick.
Yeah,
there was nothing special about it.
Yeah,
other than just looking cool.
Yeah.
I just like that red monster. I don't know what it was. It was the like new? A leech or new. Like yeah, I was like, noose. I was like, what that, is that?
And that that like big like muscly like cobra man was pretty cool.
Yeah, too. Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. They had some good stuff.
And there was a creepy looking like Satan goat man that.
Mm.
Of course, that caught my attention. Anyway, let's not read into that. All what right.
Does thou like to live deliciously, little anime boy?
Oh no.
All right, this next one is it's a sequel animated by Kyoto Animation. This is Tsurune, okay. The Linking Shot. It's about boys' archery club.
The first season of this was like...
I just like making you guys dance around the screen at this point, so...
Yeah, I know. I'm like...
It looks beautiful.
There's a movie as well, but it hasn't come out yet in English. I think High Dive is... going to maybe release it in theaters next year. So
I actually think this is really pretty.
It's gorgeous.
Yeah, it looks gorgeous. It's gonna look really, really good.
I think it's
short.
Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, this is what they've been doing.
Oh, I wanted to watch it again. That was good.
Do you guys want to watch it again? I can play it again. Sure. It was only like 15 seconds. So
yeah, why not?
Yeah, let me just rewind.
I'm considering writing it down.
Okay.
I have such a hard time with these kinds of shows.
Dude, this
story-wise,
is gorgeous.
But
yeah, the only reason I'd say maybe don't check it out is because, like, I found the first episode to be kind of boring. But
it could be boring. I can see that. But yeah. Man, it's gorgeous.
It is very pretty.
Jeff, I get it though. Like, people love Violet Evergarden and it is astonishingly beautiful, and I cannot fuck with that anime. Like, I've tried so many times and it's gorgeous, but it's just boring to me. So
yeah, I think you might not be able to get through this one.
Yeah, I was like, yeah, that was stupid pretty though. The only thing that made me think, oh, maybe it's not terribly boring is because, you know, bone arrows, maybe there was like some good action, but it didn't even show that. So I don't know.
I can tell you a little bit more about the plot. Like, it's about this guy named high schooler Minato Narumiya. He gets recruited in the Japanese archery club by his teacher, Mr. Tommy. I'm not really reading it, but, him and his friends, but also Minato is afflicted by a serious condition. So of course there's like the drama about his health or something going on at the same time. So that's all I know. But yeah.
I feel like if you're a Japanese boy that's trying to pursue any kind of like high school extracurricular activity, your odds of contracting a horrible disease just shoot way up. You need to do an investigation.
And you just and you're just gonna be going through hell in every possible way. Like something awful is gonna happen.
Yeah, it's like one of the number one comorbidities right up there with like being a mom and having hair like this.
Yeah.
Yes.
You'll notice that I've never appeared on stream with a single side ponytail, lest I, you know, have a house.
Invoke the anime reaper.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Or being the sweet and friendly, perfect childhood friend of bland everyman. You're just completely fucked. Then you're gonna
get hit by a car,
or cancer, or
a cancer car.
Cancer. Yeah. Something like that.
A truck filled with like all of the excised tumors of a bunch of recent like inpatients, and they just
runs you over. Yeah,
James, that's gross. That's really gross.
It is. I mean, that's but, you know, we got to draw attention to this horrible plight that these poor girls are facing. So.
All right.
So this next one is kind of an isekai, but it's not. And I'm a little bit interested in it. This is Saving 80,000 Gold in Another World for My Retirement. And it's about a girl who can go back and forth between her world and a fantasy world and is going to use it to make a bunch of money. So,
I like it when shows do that. Like that one restaurant show. That one. No, I can't see the video.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm just watching it by myself.
I know. I was like, she's cute. Yeah. There's a little butterfly cat. Clip. I can't speak.
So yeah,
it's kind of nice that she gets to do the whole isekai thing, but she sells like her life. So that's fun.
Yeah.
Oh, not the cat. I'm scared now. I'm scared to see any cat after that one. Yeah. Be a good cat. Yeah. Oh my, what is happening here? So yeah, not the glasses push too.
She's supposed to be taking advantage of her ability to go back and forth between two worlds, and calculate she'll need 80,000 gold coins to be able to retire. So now she has to come up with different ways to collect her gold coins. So
is it like a time dilation thing going on? Like,
I mean, she's literally, I think, going between a medieval Europe type world and modern Japan. So she'll like take stuff from modern Japan and use it in the medieval world to somehow make money. Okay, automatic. Okay.
I'm like, I'm kind of into it. At first, I wasn't feeling it at all. And there's a cat. That's not horny.
Yeah.
To our knowledge.
So far as we know. It's a nice little outfit.
Yeah.
This is cute. What is this one called?
Saving 80,000 gold in another world for my retirement.
Why with the title? Okay.
Yeah. That looks all right. I'm intrigued. I will try it. There was nothing outstanding about the production or whatever, but if it manages to be funny, then, you know, maybe.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's a different premise from most of the isekai parodies I've seen so far, so that's, like, a good sign, probably.
Yeah. Yeah.
Although I will say that if you want an isekai about, like, people unethically trying to get rich, Dungeon of Black Company, probably a much more entertaining.
I feel like I was one of the only people that really liked that that premiere when it dropped a season or two ago, but I also thought that was really funny.
That was really good. Yeah. I got to go back and watch more of it. I remember off the top of my head just the scheme he comes up with in that first episode.
I just remember it had a really bad butt in it. That's all I know.
It did. The art wasn't amazing.
Yeah, that was the big downfall of it.
Yeah. All right. This next one is for Jacki personally.
Yay!
Is it Gungrave?
Yes! Tokyo Revengers! I love this anime so much. I love it. So,
I need to watch this show. I've been hearing
I love this show.
You need to read this manga.
Okay.
I should probably.
The show is okay.
How dare you? But you know what? Again. I don't read the manga, so maybe the manga is way better than the anime. Because I love the anime.
It definitely is. There's a lot of moments in the anime where, like,
I love the characters.
Instead of animating a fight, they just like have a bunch of sound effects and then show a guy on the ground. The manga's got much better action.
Okay. Like,
much better.
Yeah, everyone's saying the manga. Well, some people are saying read the manga. Some are saying the manga fell off hard. I have no idea. All I know was that when I was watching this anime, I was so intrigued by the time element. I fell in love with like all of the characters, like all the friends.
Captain Dude!
Oh, you haven't seen this anime, Lynzee. No. It is brutal. It's like motorcycle gang mafia, you know,
They ended that trailer with shooting a guy in the head.
That's how this season ended. That's how the last season ended.
Oh my god!
Literally so the story, on that.
The story of Tokyo Revengers is about this like former delinquent who just turned into a total bitch over time. Like he got his ass kicked real bad, lost all of his confidence, became a fucking loser working at a convenience store, and then like 20 years later, the only girl who ever loved him gets murked by the Yakuza. But the Yakuza are like connected to all these delinquents who he used to know when he was a kid. So he's got to erase his way back to the past to like.
Oh no, Lynzee, we got cut off. It's a stream unavailable. Stream suspended for policy violations. I think it was because the gun.
Oh no!
Oh no!
Okay, everyone go to Twitter.
Oh no!
Everyone go to Twitter.
It's just an error. Try again. Shit.
So, okay, let me pull up the Twitter. Oh my god, this has never happened before. You think it was because of the gun violence?
I think so, yeah.
Okay.
Dude, but that trailer has to be on YouTube, right?
Yeah, we did a YouTube test with all the trailers before we did this.
Wow, I mean, that's all I could think of, right?
Yeah. Okay, here we are.
Did we cuss too much? I don't think we cussed.
We didn't cuss.
Did anybody say anything? I don't remember anyone saying anything bad.
Yeah.
No,
I'm sending go here.
Can we restart the live from YouTube?
I don't I don't know about that. So
can you like stop and restart?
I mean,
theoretically, like, right?
That, no, that would break all the links.
It would break all the links. So I would have to end the broadcast and then go back to like make a new one in StreamYard, have us all jump in and do like a brand new link. Mm. Yeah, it would break everything. So everyone's saying like Twitter is down. All right, let me go.
I can't log on. I can't log on to Twitter right now.
Okay, let me go to Twitter. I'll see what's going on. I had chat up, and then all of a sudden I saw the chat moving super fast. Everyone's like, "What the f? What the f?" And I was like, "Wait, what?" And then,
yeah, yeah,
okay.
So what are the I wonder what the policy
is. Probably it might be the gun gore or whatever. But yeah, that trailer.
Oh wait, we're back now.
Are we back?
Yeah, we're back.
Are we back? We are back.
I just clicked over and we're back.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, we're back. We're live. Hey.
Something
happened to us.
Are we really back?
Yeah, what? I saw us. I started talking on my end.
Okay.
So.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, right. yeah, we're back. We're back. Yeah,
okay. Can't keep us down.
We're back, everybody.
YouTube.
Okay, yeah, YouTube, don't. Lindsay's kidding. Haha, keep us live.
You did
just kidding. Okay. I know, exactly, dropped again. No, I'm not sure what happened there, everybody. I think that potentially some violence in the trailer might have
flagged it from the live. YouTube couldn't tell that it was animated, but
someone just said it's Tokyo Revengers' fault. I mean,
yeah. Kind of. All right.
If we were banned from Twitter, I was going to think it was the Musk jokes we were making earlier.
All right. Well,
I know. I was like, of all the things said, James has made like 10 inappropriate comments and nothing happened on YouTube.
I have been so well behaved tonight.
Oh, yeah. I said the B word. You're right. Yes, Theo, I said the B word.
He said he grows up to be a bitch. Then we got cut. So, anyway.
Wow.
It's my fault. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, everybody.
Someone just said all the gun grave talk. YouTube wasn't having it.
Oh man.
Maybe it's all the trash talk against Birdie Wing. Maybe that's what you did.
Maybe they banned us because you have terrible taste.
No. Oh, you guys. No, all right.
My heart. We're back. We're happy.
Since we're successfully back live. All right. Let's get on with number 34. Some of the people who bounced, I think, are starting to come back because their number's going back up too. All right, so let's just shoot a palate
shooting
cleanser.
People in the face in another world. That's
no, oh my gosh. No.
The next thing we are doing is called Unite Up, and it's just some nice idle stuff. So if we get dropped, it'll be for music copyright violations. Oh, this is actually a little too quiet, so I'm going to turn it up a little bit.
And then something violent happens.
There are 55 trailers total, people, and we are on number 34.
Ooh.
Two-thirds.
Everybody bounce your heads.
One more hour.
I'm not...
This is dude idols.
Where's the music?
That dude's obviously an idol because he's like wearing a disguise. He's got to be.
Like, where's that? I need some musical numbers up in here.
Here we go.
I like the dancing and singing into his baseball bat.
That was cute. I was thinking that.
Is that risky business?
Are they bathing together?
They're having. It wasn't just one. There was like three of them in there.
Three of them. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So this seems like kind of like a shonen about becoming male idols.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah,
they're all color coded. There's the pink one and the green one and the red one. It's
super cute. Yeah.
But the designs are real shonen-y. I don't know. It's like feels like they're targeting that like haiku audience specifically.
Oh yeah, I see that. I can see that. So that's anime by Cloverworks.
We didn't even get to see their squad's outfit until the very end there. So
that's true. Yeah. They're saving the good stuff for January 7th, apparently.
If I cared about idols, I'd probably be real stoked for that.
It reminds me of Idolish 7, which is one of our reviewers is a fan of that. But I mean, that already exists. It's still going. All right. I was just going to say the next one, which I'm interested in. And Jacki, I think you're interested in.
Okay,
maybe.
Let's go.
It's called Buddy Daddies.
Dude, don't get me excited. I just like, I got really excited.
Assassin Buddies.
Motorcycles, I'm in. Santa, I'm in. Oh no.
It's just so shameless.
Stop it! Oh my god, that guy was smoking hot. Go so back hot, to that right? Guy. That yeah, guy is stupid hot.
The energy stupid, in this animation stupid, is so nice.
Stupid hot. Just show that guy over and over again.
We had some tracking shots going on.
I'm obsessed. I just saw my new boyfriend for life. Oh my god, that guy is beautiful.
He's got the bags under his eyes.
I'm literally sweating right now.
The little girl is so cute too. Like the little, like the daughter that they're dragging around.
Yeah, and the little girl was cute. That okay, I'm writing that down immediately. What is that?
That looks like
buddy daddies. Buddy daddies.
Yeah,
that looks like some kind of like little bit Great Pretender, but yeah, with like more homoeroticism, and then they just added a Anya to like tie it all
that
together.
That is literally it. That was literally it. Oh, so, I'm watching that.
So the premise is you got two assassins, Kazuki Kurusu and Rei Sua. Rei is the guy with the side shave. And they meet Miri.
Love that hair. I'm like,
who's looking for her father on Christmas Day. And so they end up like, so it's two hot guys.
It's Christmas anime.
It is Christmas, and they've got this little girl, and it's animated by PA Works, the same people who did Akiba Maid War.
So, dude, I am is watching it original? The hell out of that.
Yeah.
Oh man, I'm so excited. PA Works originals are always so good, and like that Santa costume gave me like the exact vibe of like the Baccano opening when you know Isaac dresses up.
Aww.
Or wait, no, it's Miria who wears the Santa costume.
Yeah.
Whatever. Doesn't matter. Either way.
Looks good, right?
It's got energy. It's got.
Yeah. Oh, like all of the animation was so good. I'm like,
yes,
100%.
The action was good. I haven't seen like any action that had like gunfights and like people. The movement was great. I was like, that's my number one right now.
Yeah. I don't know what they have in the water at PA Works right now, but like it is, it's fire, constant fire.
Yeah. Yeah. Yay! So
this next one's got a long title, and it's a villainess anime. But what sets it apart is that one of the NPCs, who's like the prince, can hear the girls playing the game. So it's sort of like, imagine if the anime characters in these trailers we've been watching could hear all of us at the same time. Like, he keeps hearing like the secondary commentary.
Oh, like, so like it's not that they're in the world of the game, like magically, like they're inside an actively being played video game?
Yes. So Endo and Kobayashi are two characters, and they decide to play a magical romance, which is an Otome game featuring a devious villainess named Lisa Lot. Okay, Lisa Lot. Kobayashi thinks Lisa Lot is a traditionally dastardly villain, but Endo insists that Lisa Lot is just misunderstood. So they have the two friends who are playing the game have different opinions on the villainous character, and they fight and argue about her and what she's doing. But what they don't know is that Lisa Lot's in-game fiance can hear everything they're saying, and so he's in the game. So
that's interesting.
It's kind of
Wreck It Ralphie a little bit.
So that's Lisa Lot, the blonde. That's the fiance, and he can hear this. Yeah, hear these two.
Is it like a boy and girlfriend arguing about the game?
Yeah, they're either classmates. I don't know if they're in a relationship, but they're playing the game.
I mean, it'd be kind of cute
if there's like a will they won't they for them, and then there's also like the actual story of the game. Yeah. That's kind of interesting.
So wait, they both get sucked in the game?
I don't think they get sucked into it. They're just
playing it, and
playing it, and he can hear them.
I really like that.
That's hilarious.
That's a really unique premise.
Yeah.
The character designs are fine.
I like the animation a lot too.
Yeah. It's definitely expressive.
It's pretty, yeah.
So I could make out enough
the music.
Of the Japanese. Yeah. But like he overhears them saying that she's a tsundere, and he's like, what's a tsundere? She's cute, or something
she's
like
so
that.
Cute. Yeah.
Yeah.
This is kind of interesting.
I kind of like this one.
What's this one called?
I like legit think that the idea of like the, you know, these two characters offering commentary and having their own story is just like, that could potentially be brilliant.
It's a fun layer. 100% agree. What's it called?
It's got a really long title, but it's Endo and Kobayashi Live, the latest of Tsundere villainess Lisa Lot.
Yeah, especially if there's like an ongoing, like, even if it's
the latest, what? Sorry. I just need to hear that again. I didn't need to interrupt you, James.
The title is Endo and Kobayashi Live! The latest on Tsundere villainess Lisa Lot.
Lisa what?
It's Lieselotte is her name.
Lieselot.
Yeah.
Like Lancelot, but it's Lieselot. Get it? Ha ha.
It's like Lisa really Charlotte.
Yeah. Like Liesel plus Charlotte, Lieselot.
Oh, I thought it was like Lancelot, but it was Lieselot. Well, you know what? Fine. Whatever.
It's a fantasy name.
I legitimately love Japanese writers just who clearly do not speak very much English, just writing English names and just try when they try and they just don't research it and they just go.
Yeah, 100%. Like they're like, all just yeah.
Having fully,
they do not care that the title's absolutely ridiculous. They're just like, yeah, cool.
But having dived into my Gundam obsession, I have such an appreciation for stupid Gundam names. It's one of my favorite things in all of anime.
God, there's so many good ones of those in Gundam.
Like Full Frontal, the man whose name is Full Frontal. Yes, it's perfect.
Yeah. It was and Quattro Vagina.
Yes. Oh no.
And that's his fake name to cover his real name. That's the best part.
That leads to one of the greatest memes on the internet where he's like, "Come on, Amuro. If I was Char, do you really think that I would call myself Four Vaginas?"
The answer is
Char. Meanwhile, Tomino's like, he's just running.
All right.
No words.
This next one has a really easy title that tells you everything you need to know. This is Farming Life in Another World, because this is the third one in like 6 months, and we apparently needed another one. So
wait, this isn't a sequel to the.
Nope.
This is a different one?
Yep. This is a different farm in another world.
Can we?
She's kind of cute.
Yeah.
We don't have to watch this
video.
Are we X-ing farm already?
Than farming related skills, but
all right.
So is this an isekai?
He got isekai. Okay. Yep, he died of a serious illness and now he's just digging, chopping, and plowing.
He found his first hoe.
He's got a vampire.
Wait, did we X this or are we sticking with it, guys?
She's kind of cute. I don't know. Oh! I don't know.
You did not just do that in unison. Did not just do that in unison.
My home was one of. Oh no.
I don't know. I just think I'm seeing some qualities in this show now that I hadn't seen before. Oh. Big bouncy qualities.
a bountiful farm.
Okay.
Clearly this farm has.
Well, now there's a dragon.
They got the market cornered on melons.
I swear to God, this exact scene was in that one other farming anime that we had to watch last season, where there was a dragon.
No, but that one they killed it with the carrot.
Oh no, not the bath scene. All right.
My delicious. Oh,
I'm not gonna lie, that's really. So I'm not gonna lie, there are really, really cute characters and really cute animals, and the action looks okay at times. But
yeah,
we have seen worse-looking shows already.
So there you go. That's Farming Life in Another World. It includes a lot of things. That included a lot of things that happens in a fantasy farming environment.
Oh wait, we're down again, guys.
Are we really?
Maybe it was the boobs.
Was it the boobs? What?
Was it because I just said like... ho? Because I literally was pointing out that he had a farming tool.
Yeah.
But someone said damn those bouncy qualities. I don't know.
Well, I'm just going to like keep going. We're on Twitter. So.
Yeah.
And then if we're back, we're back, I guess.
Okay. Yeah. Because otherwise we're just going to keep getting delayed.
No, we are on Twitter, right?
Yeah. All right, I'm gonna keep
Twitter
going
link. Twitter. I'll take care of it. You keep on going.
Okay. Okay. So this next one is Giant Beast of Ours, and it's an original that's being made in conjunction with High Dive. And I'm actually kind of looking forward to this one, which is why I'm sad we're down right now. But yeah.
Is that ours? Is it an ORUS or
ARS? Oh, okay. Jacki, can you resend the Twitter link?
I'm trying to right now, yeah.
Sure. I closed it.
Copy so. Link to tweet. Yeah, I got it.
Okay.
This looks interesting. I don't really know what's going on.
Yeah, so the plot is a great beast created the land, but humans stole it. Angered, the beast began eating humans, who in turn called upon the gods to fight the beasts. In the age of sword heroes and mythology, giant beasts are hunted by humans for profit. Jiro makes his living hunting beasts. So.
And the art style's really slick. It's
Yeah.
Like, okay, I'm watching now.
Yeah.
Definitely Mushoku Tensei tier animation or close to it.
I like the variety and character types we're seeing.
Yeah.
Dude, those monster designs are so cool.
Yeah.
Was that a spaceship or like a?
Ooh, like not a the eye stab.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm down. Oh, yeah.
Giant Beasts of Ours.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's definitely going high on the list for
me. I thought that was a pretty promising looking trailer, to be honest.
Yeah.
I didn't get to see a lot of it, but what I saw was nice. So,
and is that an original? Is that an adaptation?
We're back again.
Yes. All right.
Hi, everybody.
Hi. Sorry. Yeah. YouTube is really.
You all just missed one of the better trailers, too. I'm like, sorry, guys.
Yeah.
Giant Beast of Ours.
Giant Beast of Ours, because that one looks really good. Actually, I have links to every single trailer in my cheat sheet.
Let's play it one more time.
All right.
I honestly missed it because I was heading.
Yeah.
Putting the Twitter link out.
All right.
Oh my gosh, she's adorable.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm really down for this. I just,
the magic, the animation's like
good,
reminding
right?
me of Mushoku Tensei in a really good
well,
way.
Well, and it has, the character designs are really strong without kind of breaking out of the more kind of grounded-ish art style that it's going for, if that makes any sense.
Oh, the cat on the head.
Yeah.
There's a little cat girl, too.
Lots of really good shots, too.
The animation's nice.
I love this one coming up.
This one seems like a magical girl transformation, but like smart.
Yeah.
Someone wrote giant piece of arse, and I'm not going to not be able to hear that now.
Elephant's thing looks so
silly. Guys, we can't get banned again.
That was dope.
Yeah, I like when she runs up the wall.
That sick wall run? Yeah.
Yeah, like the animators are clearly having fun with this. The characters all look really good.
This is really good.
And the whole world has an aesthetic that feels fantasy, but it doesn't feel generic, which I love.
Yeah.
This is solid.
That's going right to the top.
Yeah, I think it's number one for sure. And I really thought Buddy Daddies could not be knocked because that guy was stupid hot.
Yeah.
Dude, Lynzee, he literally came on the stream, I just started screaming. I was like, he's so hot. She just knows my type to a T.
I do.
That was too funny. Yeah.
So that's Giant Beast of Ours. That'll be on High Dive. It's a co-pro with High Dive, not based on anything.
Oh,
so.
It's a High Dive exclusive?
Yeah.
They've been getting some really sick shows.
Yeah, I mean, what was it? Pantheon was really good, too.
Oh, I haven't watched that. I know about the webcomic. Yeah.
Do you like Akiba Maid War?
Akiba Maid War is literally like... other than Bocchi the Rock, I think my favorite new.
Seriously, like we were obsessed. So
yeah,
I think that was only in High Dive, right?
I put out like two separate videos talking about Akiba Maid War.
It was so good.
Yeah,
too good.
All right,
as a 35 year old about to turn 36, and just Bronco is my like everything. But anyway,
I fell in love with that show from like literally the first minute you know that like quiet like film noir scene with the maid shootout.
Yeah,
so good.
Yeah.
I think the ending theme of episode one was when I realized it was going to be a masterpiece. And I was like, oh, they know exactly what they're doing. They're turning it up to 11.
I think, James, you were watching that one and then you were like, y'all should watch this one. And then that ended up being like the main anime we talked about for the entire season. Am I wrong or did I make that up? Okay.
Well, Chainsaw Man as well, but yeah.
Well, Chainsaw, we talked about both, but we all knew Chainsaw Man was going to be nuts. Like, Akiba Maid War was just such like an underdog dark horse and it was perfection. But anyway, sorry.
Never apologize for talking about Akiba Maid War.
Agreed.
That's what every anime content, everything should be until the end of time. Just more Akiba Maid War.
Yeah, I want Sega to make a Yakuza reskin with Akiba Maid War characters.
Akiba strip is actually very, very close to what you want in a lot of ways, and I would highly recommend checking it out.
I have it on the Vita only, but I think it's probably on sale for PS4. It's like always on sale.
But it is like actually like a Yakuza style game.
Okay, sweet.
Especially the sequel adds like more stuff to do. The first one's just kind of a beat 'em up where you can hang out in the city and buy stuff. But like, surprisingly good for that if you want to hang out in Akiba in a Yakuza. Oh, yeah. I'm sorry. I just like got halfway through that sentence.
This next one is based off a game I've never played. Maybe one of us have played it and can talk about
it. I have.
I played the other Trails games. I haven't played Cold Steel.
I got it right here. I got. Oh, I'm so excited.
I have all of these games. I haven't gotten to them because I've been waiting to play the Crossbell duology. Is that the one?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, it's not strictly necessary to appreciate the story of... this is Crossbell, by the way. This is the new... I'm obsessed with these games.
Apparently.
This is the One Piece, the Lord of the Rings of JRPGs.
Yeah.
This world is so insanely...
How do I not know detailed. This?
Yeah.
It's called the two Trails in the Sky games.
Legend of Heroes. So it's the Legend of Heroes Trails series. There's Trails in the Sky.
Yeah, never played them.
Yeah. They're
you guys are hyping it up though. Like, it looks really cool.
Yeah.
I love it so much.
I lost an entire summer to playing the two Trails games on the Vita that I got.
So this looks like it might be an original story because it doesn't look like the plot of the first Cold Steel game.
Yes,
I think it's a good thing though, isn't it?
It's good. Yeah, they're not going to try to cram the whole game into like the whole one season.
But also, like, it would be impossible, I think, to create like a version to like tell that story in an anime, because like the thing that makes the Trails games great, I mean, there's two things. One, it's Nihon Falcom. They design really good combat systems. It's very well balanced and fun and challenging. But two, every single NPC in the game has a name and personality and like relationships with other NPCs. And every single time you do a mission, every character gets updated dialogue that like continues their storyline. So like the shopkeeper in town who you're friends with, who hooks you up with like your exclusive sneakers from the big city, his mom becomes concerned that he's so single over the course of that part of the thing. And then like every time you come back to town, she's gone and propositioned a different one of the eligible bachelorettes in town, and he's really embarrassed about it, and like you can talk to them about it. And then like later you go to like a small town and this guy's complaining about his neighbor. It's just so dense as like worlds go.
Treasure chest in the game has like a little unique conversation that you have with it.
Oh wow.
You open the chest and then afterwards there's like a unique message where it's like, this chest is empty, who could do such a thing? Or
oh my gosh,
it's just every text box in those games is
so this delight. Anime will probably be pretty good for people who are familiar with the story already and have played the games, but
I like, it seems like they're doing the Edgerunners thing where it's like a story set in the world. And I think with the characters, but it, I might also just not be, oh, it happens between Cold Steel 2 and 3. Okay. See, I haven't finished Cold Steel 2 yet because like you, I was waiting for Crossbell and I wanted to like go back. Right now I'm going back and playing through the entire Liberal arc, which is the first one. Because I got a Steam Deck and that's the best way to play the Trails series.
I'm playing Trails the Third right now, and it is great. So, yeah.
Yeah.
So this next one might get us banned from YouTube.
Oh, no. Why?
Again. It required a consent button.
Oh, great.
Can you make it? Is there a way to make the screen small? So maybe it's like, I think that like when it's big, and like their AI catches something that it could get us in trouble, i.e. big, you know what? Gun.
Stuff. I think if you leave it at the...
Yeah, instead of full screening it, just...
Maybe, just, let's try, because I was like, maybe, because I think that's it, the AI just picks up something and then it's like, this isn't right or something, so...
Yeah, so this
I could be completely wrong.
This is going to stream on High Dive.
Is this the dog anime?
This is the dog anime. This God, is my life as Inukai-san's dog.
You know what? You know what? I know
I will
about
play
this manga.
It until Yazzie's you guys told exit. Me about,
in the manga, a girl sucks on a dog's tail like it's a dick.
We don't want to get banned.
We don't have to watch this one.
All right.
We do not have to watch this one.
All right.
Yeah, if we didn't know. Yeah, I was like, I'm in.
If people in the chat skip it, don't get banned again. All right, so that's a thing. You know, if you're of age and you would like to go watch this trailer, here's the link so you can all go watch it yourself. This is a story about a
guy. Dude, why anime? Why anime? Why?
As well. That, this is the most why anime
why
since since Redo of Healer, maybe before. It's
oh, that's
this one's
for the record. I watched the trailer before the stream, so I knew what we would be getting into.
Was it bad?
There's some panty shots in the trailer, and I mean, she's got a wet shirt, there's no tail situation like what Geoff talks about in the trailer. It's just very obvious. Like, most of the anime is you're in the dog's perspective, so you're like low to the ground looking up. And, you know, she dotes on him and pets him and stuff. And then, you know, you can see their panties when they're all sitting in their room because it's a bunch of girls with a dog. They're not thinking about it. So anyway,
it will
stream on High Dive. And I gave you guys all the link so you can go watch it. We've already had, you know, I don't know if YouTube's got a three strikes rule. So maybe.
Exactly. Yeah, I was like, don't even remotely mess with that.
So we'll go straight from I'm a dog and I got to see you in your panties to Nijion Animation, which is a spinoff of Love Live. So, you know, not problematic probably at all. So here you go. I can go back to full screen now, right? Okay.
Is this like an isekai quartet, but with all the Love Live girls from every Love Live?
I think it's actually only the Love Live Nijigasaki series girls, and it's just like a four coma comedy spinoff, so this might be shorts even, and they've got a little goofy
is it
character
CGI
designs.
Yeah, that's really impressive.
Yeah, it looks good.
That's like actually like those are really good character models.
It was cute. Good. I won't ever watch that though. So
me neither. Never in a million years. But I'm very
I don't know who any of them are, and I'm sure you would need to in order to appreciate it at all.
I like the
art style of this one.
This one is Sugar Apple Fairy Tale, and this will stream on Crunchyroll.
Is this going to be anything
Apple
like
Fairy
that?
Tale?
Or is that that one
Happy
show about
Sugar
the girl
Life
that kidnapped that little kid?
Happy Sugar Life. No.
A girl named Anne, and she's a candy crafter, and she wants to become like the best candy person in all the land. And she buys a guy, he's a fairy, a foul-mouthed fairy, to be her bodyguard. So there is kind of a slavery situation going on here. But
I think
she wants
it looks
to be
really nice.
Yeah.
equal opportunity slavery, though, which is.
I guess so.
I mean, it's time that the women had their turn, okay?
Like, this is not progress.
This is not. I know. Lindsay and I are like, no, it's not. Good. It's not
progress. Isn't that?
So now I feel bad because, like, he's hot. Am I allowed to say that he's hot? I don't.
No, I know, Lindsay. I was like, I ain't saying shit.
You're like, I'm out. I'm just not. I'm not part of this.
Yeah, I was like, I'm good. I'm not gonna lie, but this is actually really pretty.
Yeah,
it's
weird
gorgeous.
Concept, but yeah.
And I love Japanese candies. So yeah. Like,
ooh, she made butter.
That was beautiful.
Oh, I guess
he's good action too.
Was that little fairy covered in blood?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm. James.
It's a hard enough life being a candy maker, you know?
Fairy covered in blood?
She was.
Okay.
This like looks pretty good though. I don't know.
I agree. I agree.
Yeah.
Like animation solid. I like the character design. There's action here.
I legitimately love the way they do the eyes. Like, yeah. That's...
It's really pretty. Sugar Apple Fairy Tale.
Oh.
I'll write
it's
it
a
down.
Shame about the slavery, but you know.
Yeah, I know, right? It's like, why anime? Why, dude? Just, like, couldn't he
but
just
be a
friend?
But what anime can't you say that about?
I know, it's true. It's true. Is there one anime where we can't say why anime? Why?
I don't know. This...
Bocchi the Rock, actually, is a great
Yeah, Bocchi the Rock, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
K-On? I mean, K-On, there's really nothing.
Okay.
Except the fans.
Wow. Yeah.
So,
no. Okay, let's keep on rolling. What are we at, 40 almost?
We're at 43. We are at the home stretch now.
10-ish, everybody.
10-ish left. This next one is the Ice Blade Sorcerer Shall Rule the World. It's about a dude who's really OP, and then he retires and decides to go to school, and then everyone mocks him, even though he's like a war hero, and it doesn't make any sense. But
Rude. Yeah, I was like,
okay,
what?
Who's that guy? They opened on like a dude who was like a serious scare.
Did you see that fucking that blood explosion?
Yeah. What just happened?
Anytime I see, oh my god, those effects. Wow. I'm gonna have a field day with this.
Guys,
I don't
Gohan
know if
secretly
else
animated
ever
this.
Be... No, the like production values on this are special kind of awful. This is a special kind of awful. I can already tell. This is gonna be one of my hottest trash.
Whoa, he's actually buff though. What? There's so many things happening in this trailer.
I kind of shut down a little bit. It was kind of a sensory overload for me.
Yeah, sensory overload, James. Totally. Like, I didn't even know what I was processing.
Was that? Wait, go back. Was that Glass Reflection?
What? The song?
No, go back. This Glass Reflection, Sarkata.
Oh yeah, there he is. Like, yeah,
the Arcata vest.
Yeah.
See?
Yeah.
See?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, what?
They're all dressed like Glass Reflection.
What is Glass Reflection?
Arcata on YouTube. Glass Reflection.
He's an anime YouTuber. Oh,
yeah.
Oh, okay.
But like
I also was trying to think of what anime is Glass Reflection. And then
right? But you know what I'm talking about, and that's exactly his vest.
Wow.
It is.
And that's all I can see now. I'm sorry. Every time it's just like, it's fucking Tristan's right there.
I think my brain is fried because everything we just watched
was like garbage. It's just
everything I just watched just went like, I don't even know what I processed. Yeah, exactly. It was like too much.
Anyway, that was Ice Blade Sorcerer, everybody. This next one is a fantasy series that's on like, it's technically season 4, but it's the second part of season 4. So it's season 4 part 2. Anyway, you all know what this is. Is it wrong to try to pick up girls in the dungeon? 4. Part 2.
Ooh.
I watched the first 2 seasons of the show, and I really
I watched a little bit of the first, yeah.
Caitlin, the dumpster fire was the Ice Blade Sorcerer Shall Rule the World. Since you're asking in the chat, yeah.
I need to catch up on the show. I liked the first 2 seasons.
Me too. I liked it, and I think it just kind of got lost in the mix for me. So, and I'm kind of mad at myself because watching this, it looks dark as hell. And I like dark.
Got some CG dragons.
Yeah, no? I didn't love the CG dragons, I'll be honest. But I liked all the blood and darkness in the beginning.
Jacki.
Sorry. Baddie, love
her. Yeah, there's some baddies in this, for real.
There's a lot of baddies in.
Yeah,
in
I was gonna say.
I mean, like, the whole premise is picking up baddies in the dungeon.
Yeah.
It's true.
Is the redhead new?
Yeah, she's from season 3, I think, okay. Or maybe 2.
Yeah, I didn't recognize her.
No, yeah, sorry. She's their blacksmith, I think.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Maybe I'm thinking of. I haven't. I only caught up on season 2 as well. I gotta get through it.
And yeah, I didn't
skeleton army.
Bad. I just
love a skeleton army. Sorry.
Yeah. No, I love the series. I just too busy to follow. Hestia is Bestia.
Yeah,
Hestia
I feel like everyone loved this anime. Like I remember it was like. Trending on TikTok really hard, and then it kind of like fell off, but it was like people were obsessed, I remember. But I don't know, like, yeah. I said, first episode or first
trip.
Season
it is a long super trailer long. Yeah,
I don't know if I'm just burnt out because we've watched so many trailers. It's like it looks good, but I'm just like, I don't know.
Yeah, well, I would need to watch the whole other season and a half before
that too. Yeah. Yeah, I feel like I'm just intimidated. Like I'm like, oh my god, there'd be so much I'd have to catch up on.
A lot to watch.
Yeah,
keep on going. I'm not yawning. You're yawning.
Okay,
me.
So this is another one that got requires permission to watch. It's on Crunchyroll's channel though, guys, and if it
but they have special relationships with YouTube. We're peons to Crunchyroll.
So this one is called Onimai, I'm Now Your Sister. And it's about a dude who liked erotic games. And then he wakes up as a woman and his sister's a little mad scientist and she turned him into a girl. So that's what
Whoa.
There is to know about that.
There are so many ways to go wrong.
The sister turned her brother into a girl?
I believe so, through a failed experiment. She tried out an experiment on him, and that's what it caused.
Oh, a tiny girl. Okay.
Yeah. Why do the characters...
A lot of anime Y stuff.
Yeah, there's already, I'm just imagining the meeting where it's like, all right, now where's our guy that...
Is this...
Great for drawing the pants falling off of the tiny girl.
Just a random question. Is this Doga Kobo?
I think it is. I don't know for a fact, but
I was
going to
say,
I
didn't say at the beginning of the stream, but there was like a couple years of there where Doga Kobo had like one of those shows every single season.
Yeah.
We all had to sit through it, and I hadn't seen him in a while, and now here. Something.
I don't know why that one is flagged.
The animation's really cute. Like,
yeah.
Like,
animation's cute. I don't want to watch that story at all.
Saying, if it wasn't for the little red flag cuts where it's like they spent a little too much time animating that scene, it would look cute, but I'm just concerned. Mm-hmm.
No.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's that's why I asked. Is it Doga Kobo?
Yeah, I'm not. Yeah, I'd have to look it up, but I'm pretty sure it is Doga Kobo on that. If anyone wants to hop in the comments. And Google it, but
what was it called again?
Onimai, I'm Now Your Sister.
I'm Now Your Sister.
It's Onimai. Onimai.
Studio Bind.
Studio Bind. Okay. Oh, yeah. They're the people who animated Mushoku Tensei.
Oh, okay.
Everything makes sense.
Okay, Studio Bind. Oh, I mean
that explains
why
it looks so good.
So good. Yeah.
Because I was going to say, that looks kind of good for Doga Kobo. They're not usually as on point.
No, their animation's always really, really good.
No, I was more just like the colors and like the expressiveness of the art to me just seemed a little off-brand.
Yeah.
A little more vibrant, a little more stylized than at least what I remember of the shows.
The dynamism of it definitely reminds me of Mushoku Tensei.
Yeah.
Makes sense that it's Studio Bind on many levels.
All right. This next one's got a big name attached to it, but I no longer trust in it whenever I see it, thanks to other projects. This is Revenger that Gen Urobuchi is somehow involved with. He's listed as a scriptwriter, but so is somebody else. And they've faked us out on this a few times as far as like trying to make something a Gen Urobuchi joint.
It's going to be like Bubble, where he literally wrote down bubbles and parkour on a napkin, and that got him like the executive producer credit. Yeah.
But this is a samurai stuff. It's got gorgeous samurai dudes in it.
So he's attractive.
I already know
a lot of good looking guys this season, Jacki.
Seriously, yeah. Like this guy's beautiful.
His crossed bag.
I might just watch this for eye candy alone.
Yeah.
I don't like
also,
this.
Oh, she's cute.
These backgrounds are real primo.
Yeah.
Like
this looks good.
Get some good lighting going.
Did that guy bite a hole?
I know. I was just thinking that.
Ooh, wait, did you see that archer up there? Like, okay, and that dude reminds me of Samurai Champloo. Like, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, we got none. There's a none. Oh, we're let's go.
Okay.
With a back tattoo. Okay.
Ugh, this is
all the fade haircuts. I can't right now.
So I guess
they're also handsome.
Yeah.
Revenger.
Okay.
That one's going near the top for me.
Yeah, for me too. Me too.
Yeah, I was skeptical, but that trailer won me over on the hype for that. General plot, Raizo Kurima is a man who was betrayed by someone he trusted, and now he has no place to return. He's now a hitman working for an organization called Revenger, which takes revenge on behalf of those who have no power. So kind of like a Robin Hood sort of deal, only with murder, I think.
Yeah.
So. Yeah.
Sounds fun.
Yeah.
Sounds a little stupid, to be honest, but like, damn, that looks cool.
Yeah, that was a good trailer cut for sure.
Gen Urobuchi does good stupid, though. Like, his stupid ideas can be solid. So,
Thunderbolt Fantasy, right?
Yeah, he's Thunderbolt Fantasy.
So, yeah.
He knows. Yeah.
He's extremely genius, like just so extreme and crazy. So I'm here for it. But wait, you said he's just a name on it, a producer on it?
He's a script writer on it, but he's a co-writer on it. There's another writer. Okay.
So is it one of those things where he like gave another writer the story idea and then it's going to all know a zero on us?
That's what I'm worried about.
Yeah, that's what I'm worried about too. I'm like, co-writer, such a weird... title. It's like,
I'm just what so learned by Bubble. That movie like kind of sucked. And
did it? I haven't seen it yet, but
it was just okay. Yeah, this is also, this isn't based on another work. Teo asked in the comments. It's original.
Urobuchi's really good when he writes his own stuff, but like, man, anytime somebody else takes over his stories, like I'm just thinking like the Madoka spinoffs. The Psychopath sequels.
I like Magia Record. I will stand that.
You do?
Busted show. Yeah, it's not great, but I think it's underrated. I think that show deserves a bit more love.
Okay, but the Psychopath sequels, though.
What
Psychopath sequels?
Yeah.
I never. They don't exist.
Yeah.
But didn't even watch the sequel to that. Yeah. All right, this next
you're gonna
one.
Tell me that they made a Promise Neverland sequel, so you gotta stop it.
that's absurd.
That's so mean. So inappropriate.
This one is based on some light novels, and it has spies in it, but it's not Spy Family. And
we're talking like Bond spies or like Born Identity
Spy Classroom.
I don't know. Live in Quarantine.
Bond spies.
Okay. I'm already loving the look of this, though.
Yeah.
Bond spies. Flower petals?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Can you turn it up a little?
Sure.
I want to see more of the actual animation.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I'm kind of, like, loving this, though.
Yeah.
This kind of gives me a Princess Principal vibes.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God. This can totally be up my alley. Spy Room.
I want to see more than the key art before I
know. I agree. Yeah.
Yeah.
But I am intrigued by that teaser, though. Yeah. Like, I need
if it's
to
coming
see
out
more, but...
this season. It's like, is this like a production? Like, or...
Oh, wait. There was another trailer there. There is.
Here, let me get that.
Okay.
Let me go back. Let me.
Because the character designs look great, but
I checked the high dive. channel before I did this, so I don't know.
Oh, if
this,
so it like, looks like they're fully off. Animated PVs. There's just not any subs, but that's fine.
Well, this one, no, this has subs. Oh, this is on high dive. Okay, so here we go. Here's
the world is filled with pain. I love it.
We still haven't seen any animation though. This is going the exact same way as the last one. Information warfare by spies. The Shadow War.
Turn the volume up. I like this music.
Okay.
Okay, okay, okay.
He's pretty hot, I think.
Yep.
That was
Jeff, I think.
I don't know. I'm just assuming.
I'm loving these characters right now.
Yeah. There's still a this looks like a video game trailer, not an
It anime. Does look like a video game trailer. I totally agree with you.
Really good cast to say you already though.
Yeah. Oh my god, I love Monica's voice. Oh, Thea just had to one-up her in every way. Like, okay.
So if you go to the official Japanese website, as I've said in the comments, there are individual trailers for each character. I usually don't pick character trailers for this show because it doesn't need to be good.
Eye patch girl with the pink hair and pigtails. Okay.
Okay, here we go. There's a little, yeah.
We've technically seen animation.
Yeah.
Lips have flapped.
Excuse me.
Gosh, there's not a lot to go with, but it like I like what I see.
I like the vibe. List, but... I like the vibe. I like the graphics. The animation looks a little, you know. It looks like
that we haven't seen a lot.
Yeah.
It looks like there's probably going to be like a lot of talking heads and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. But in an espionage story, that's not necessarily the worst thing.
True. If the writing is good, that could work.
Yeah.
I love the girl characters.
The designs are really good. Yeah. I'll definitely try it. There are probably trailers with more animation, but they've instead cut them so each one focuses on a different girl. And I didn't know which one to, like, who am I supposed to pick for an introductory trailer, right? Like, which girl? So if you go over to the Japanese website or Anime News Network has articles every time a new one comes out, you can go watch those and there might be some more animation in them. Yeah. But yeah, I'm going to write that one down.
What was that one called?
Spy Classroom. It's actually Spy Classroom.
A Spy Classroom?
Okay. Yeah. I don't know why they're calling it Spy Room in the subtitles of that trailer.
Spy Room is the production committee.
Gotcha. Yeah. Okay. So this next one's number 48. And this is the fourth season. I fell off during the third season of this. I really want to go back and watch it. This is Bungo Stray Dog season 4. Jacki, if you ever feel like you have time, I think you would like this show as well. It's got a lot of
feel
battles.
Like
I keep getting mixed messages on whether this show is worth
I really want to get into Bungo Stray Dogs, but like I feel like to do it right, I should read some Bungo first and actually, like
appreciate know about the
Japanese literature before I'm going into a shonen battle where all of the battle things are deep cut references.
Well, some of them are based off English authors as well, so not everyone's a Japanese author.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I just say there's one guy in here like, who I've read a couple of his short stories, but I think that's about it.
Yeah,
you like Conan Doyle and Edgar Allan Poe are in this one too.
It's also animated by Studio Bones, so it consistently looks really, really good.
It looks really good.
Yeah,
like I'm like, I should be watching this.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just hot author boys beating each other up with their magic author powers.
Yeah.
Lynzee, I feel like this is so up your alley.
I have watched the first two seasons and the movie, but I need to watch season 3, which was the one right before this.
Is this in Crunchyroll?
Yes, I think so.
Oh, then it's probably does it have a dub?
Yeah, oh, it definitely has a dub by now, yeah.
Okay, because this is my thing. If it's got a lot of seasons, which to me is like 2+. If I can watch some of it in the background via dub, then I'm okay. But if I have to like commit and watch it like subbed for like multiple seasons back to back, it's hard for me. So
yeah,
I'm like,
yeah.
I can throw it on in the background.
There's definitely a dub.
I could throw it on in the background and get caught up.
Yeah, yeah.
This is another one. I think I might need to tell my wife about this because that jester looking guy seems like he'd be right up her alley.
Oh, she into clowns, James?
Oh, yes.
Your wife's into clowns?
Absolutely.
Oh, no.
No judgment.
Yeah, no judgment, but oh, no.
No judgment.
No judgment, but oh, no.
No
That's
judgment.
Scary, James. Isn't it funny how
the more you say no judgment,
the more you start to judge. Yeah, exactly. I'm like, okay, we'll just stop there. Okay, yeah. I like that one. I like that one a lot.
Yeah. Yeah, that one's gonna be a good time. It's got there's a thriving fandom community for Bungo Stray Dogs.
It got me to write it down, catch up on Bungo Stray Dogs.
Yeah, I put it on my other list too.
Yeah, I mean I haven't caught up on Vanitas either, and that's also Bones full.
Also,
Bones,
very good point.
So, yeah. There's just so much anime. There's too much good anime. I'm upset.
There's so much. This next one is a rom-com with a little bit of like a supernatural flair. Characters aren't in high school. Just want to point that out. This is about an office worker, and he is descended from Yukionas, which are traditionally like ice yokai women, but it's a guy in this case. And his female coworker, maybe she's into it. I don't know. So here we go. This is the ice guy and his cool female colleague.
It'd be great if it was just Ice King from Adventure Time.
Wouldn't it?
I would watch the shit out of that. Yeah. Ice King trying to get like a date in Tokyo. That sounds like an amazing
character. It can be this character, just have Tom Kenny do the voice.
Yeah.
Oh, there's others. Okay, so she's like a kitsune then. I didn't think there were gonna be like other supernatural people hanging out. She's cute.
Aww. Always love my red-haired boys.
I miss Noragami.
She's adorable. Really I love her hair.
I think that's his little sister. Her name is Yuki, which is incredibly on brand if you're a Yuki owner.
These are fine.
Yeah.
Oh, the little snowmen. I love little snow people.
That looks cute.
Super cute.
Oh, sorry, there was more? After the credits? He fell asleep on her on the train. Okay, that was
cute.
That looks wholesome.
Yeah.
Next.
Yeah, I was like, next.
So next is...
We're getting close, right?
We are. This is number 50, okay?
Ooh. Okay, so we only have 5 left, right?
Only 5 left.
I mind hanging out with you guys.
No, I'm sorry. These are so fun for the first 2 hours, and then the last hour, we're all like,
please.
It's so true. But
it doesn't. Okay. I mean, and I'll be the one to say it. I know we still got 5 to go, but there's not a lot to work with this season.
Yeah,
compared to.
Oh, James, you're gonna eat your tiny little hat.
I know what you've saved for the last batch, but I'm just saying that out of 50.
It's always like this.
So this next one, I'm actually interested in it because it's about two girls hanging out in a fantasy world being cool and stuff. So this is the magical revolution of the reincarnated princess.
Cameo by mom, by the way, everybody.
Hi, Jacki. What are you still doing in here?
She is. She's like, what are you doing? She's like, I need to get some gloss.
Title is writing Utena checks, and I don't know that this anime can cash. But...
Is she wearing a dire wolf pelt?
Yeah. Yes. So the idea here is that the princess defies the aristocracy's expectations by developing magicology, which is a unique magical theory based on memories from her past life. And then she witnesses the brilliant noblewoman, Euphelia, unjustly stripped of her title as the kingdom's next monarch. And so they team up together to restore her good name while researching magic.
Do they date?
I hope so.
Okay.
Oh, please tell me this one's gay. Please.
Jacki is bored.
No, I'm dead. This looks sweet. I don't like the title Magicology. It reminds me too much of Terryology, but other than that...
I don't know what that is. What's that?
Terry Crews's... Terrence Howard Jr. proprietary mathematical system that he developed. Google it. It's a fun time.
I will not, but thank you.
They're really pretty. All the girls are pretty. That's about it for me.
Oh, look,
she got broom.
Okay, next.
Didn't see much in that to back up the plot.
The characters are really pretty. The girls are like adorable and gorgeous, yeah. But I was like, all right.
The concept makes me think I'll probably like it once I get into it, you know?
Yeah. Not me.
Which we have some subtitles and, you know, some story to work with. Yeah.
What's the name on this one? That was The Magical Revolution of the Reincarnated Princess. So that's what that one's called. All right, number 51 is called Technoroid Overmind, and it has androids. That's all I think they're like attractive men because we haven't seen enough of those yet, I guess. So
are they like idols or?
I don't know. There's barely any sound right now.
They're color coded.
Oh, that's they are color coded. They live in an empty house. The four of them were trying to get a prize at the Entertainment Tower Babel to pay off a huge debt. Meanwhile, a special program begins to operate for the four of them when they meet Isora, a boy who lost his father.
I'm gonna be honest. This kind of looks like shit.
Yeah, I don't. I can't. It doesn't help for that.
I love that Jeff's like, this looks like shit. This looks so bad.
It looks really bad.
I'm sorry. Like, come on.
You don't want to watch 2 minutes of this?
No, I'm good.
For sure.
You all are evil. You all are evil. All
right.
Actually, I like this song.
It is catchy.
I do like this song.
This is one of those shows that's going to come out on like a preview guide day where there's like 8 episodes and I'm going to save it for the very end because I'm dreading it and it's going to feel like an hour and a half long.
Yeah.
But I can tell already.
This is so bad. It's amazing.
I like...
They revolt. They become sentient and they revolt and they kill their human masters. That'll be
good. It's legitimately rare to see like an anime art style that manages to look like as obnoxious as a Yu-Gi-Oh! Without doing any of the spiky hair stuff. Just like the colors. They're so bad. That's.
I want Will Smith to come in and just start shooting them all.
Yeah.
Too funny. Okay.
All right. It's like straight awesome for the next 4. Okay, so,
let's go.
All right.
Okay, let's go.
All right.
Let's knock some of the stuff off my top 10.
All right, this is Tomo-chan is a Girl, which is a rom-com about... It's got subtitles, so.
I like the voice acting already. Very charming. I mean, as long as this doesn't end up doing that thing where like she has to glorify herself,
that kick animation was real good. As long as she doesn't what?
I say, as long as it doesn't end up doing that thing where like she has to glorify herself in order to.
Oh yeah.
But it doesn't look. Doesn't seem like that's gonna be.
Turn it down a little. Sorry. Yeah. I don't. Because there is that really feminine character. I'm like, I hope they don't do like a makeover, like she's all that sort of situation for her. Like, they should date and she should keep wearing biker shorts and kicking people's ass at the same time.
Yeah. That's cute though. I like that.
Yeah.
I like that. That was cute.
Yeah.
Definitely.
That had charm. Cute.
Yeah.
Animation was solid too, I thought.
I think the voice acting for that main character is really going to sell it. I think she was really charming in that.
Yeah, I liked her voice.
Studio Orange?
Yeah, Trigun.
Jacki, your mom's going to come back. You haven't seen it yet?
I could cry.
It's happening right now. I feel like beautiful. I just gave you $1,000,000.
I'm so glad I got to see this happen in real time.
To my core. Oh my gosh. I'm like literally about to cry.
Hey, Jack, do you like Vash?
I love Vash. Vash, he's got the fade haircut. You already know. Jackie's a fan.
This CGI looks so good.
Yeah. I know. I'm like,
no one does it better than Orange. Like,
oh, Wolfwood.
I'm dying. I am literally. Oh my god. I can't even talk right now.
So, when you put anything that Orange does, but specifically this next to oh my god, I just got the name of the studio.
Polygon.
The amount of expressiveness that they are capturing with these facial animations is so good.
This looks really good. I'm really happy right now.
Whoa! He just took something out of his mouth.
Absolutely gorgeous.
Was that Legato there with the blue hair? I liked Legato when I watched the original. Surprising no one, but
like I could watch this trailer on repeat a few times.
Wow, that looked I'm like I'm sweating. I like almost started crying. I'm so happy with that. I don't even know where to start.
Yeah, that's gonna be amazing.
Wolfwood was my favorite character for like so long. Like I don't know why. I just like loved his personality so much because I just felt like he wasn't, you know, like we all love Vash, right? Because he's like the showy, funny, you know, like super not suave, but trips over himself. But you know, like he's the cool one, right? Like Wolfwood was like the disciplined, like principled one who like I just felt like was overshadowed. But for some reason, I just always loved Wolfwood. I'm geeking the F out. I'm dying. I'm so excited. That's the top of my list, like easily.
Yeah.
Sorry, y'all. I'm sure y'all have already watched that trailer. That was my first time experiencing it.
I hadn't either, so
like that got me so hyped. Oh my god. Anyway, okay. So what's next?
I've got the original Trigun theme just like playing in the back of my head.
I got those Toonami adverts.
To be honest, I was a little bit worried about this remake because it was just I forgot when it specifically came out, if it was like early 2000s or late 90s, but you know, it was like that vibe and that artwork and that animation. And I was just like, how are they going to modernize that? You know, like I genuinely was afraid and I really liked what I saw. So I think that's why I was getting so excited. Cause like, then I was like, whoa, cause I saw the CG and I didn't really care. Cause it was just like Vash and my friends, you know? But then when I saw that it actually looked pretty good and the action was solid, like I was like blown away, you know?
I think it's a really great modern update of the visual design of Trigun. And like, that's really hard to do. Cause that is one of like the most iconic aesthetics, I think, of the entire 90s anime.
True.
And like, it did kind of bum me out to not see all the giant light bulbs and stuff like that, you know, but like in the same, you know, like, cause it's just, I think Trigun's like one of the most classically diesel punk.
Yeah.
Visual. It's just the visuals in that original series.
I would
so
put
good.
Like for diesel punk, it's like Trigun and Eat Man 98. Yeah, those are kind of, they've got a similar aesthetic, but Trigun's definitely the way more popular one of the two.
And there's just like, I would honestly be concerned about even trying to like emulate that with like modern digital techniques and make it look as good as it did in cell animation. So I think it's just really good that they modernized and updated the look of it. And that way we get like two really good looking Trigun animes that tell the story in their own way.
Instead of
you know, like Trigun and then Trigun again but 3D.
Oh my god, I'm sorry, I think I blew someone's eardrums out. Gunpla said we're out. Jackie's mic is blowing our eardrums. He tried to hang as long as he could but can't enjoy with all the cross. Is it my mic? Is it super loud?
It just when you got really loud.
Okay like that. I'm like, I'm so sorry, I was so excited. That was wild.
Okay. We've literally only got
a couple more, so we've got two
trailers left, and this one, I don't know, maybe it'll make James scream. This one's for James. So
I know what this is.
You know, do you know what it is, James?
Oh, I know.
Up.
This is the one that dropped today. So it doesn't have subtitles, but this is the Nier Automata version 1.1A anime. I have not played this game. I'm sorry, everybody. But I mean,
I haven't either, to be honest. I played the original Nier, which makes me kind of
also
weird,
great.
I think, but...
Also great.
I have never played this, and I'm like, how have I not played this? Like, I should.
Honestly, to be perfectly honest, the only reason I'm not exploding for hype for the show is that almost everything that makes Nier one of the greatest games ever made, both of them, I don't think translates at all into any medium other than video games. So I'm actually really curious to see what people are
visually.
Make
I think
of this
it looks really good.
Yeah,
yeah,
it looks incredible.
Great.
Yeah, I'm gonna watch it obsessively, but I'm just wondering if there are people that might like watch it and go, oh, well, that was good, but and I'm gonna have to be one of those people that's like, no, but you don't understand. You don't understand how good it can be. Yeah. But it looks incredible.
Well, yeah, I mean, any of those games, you have to like play through at least a couple times to even start fully appreciating the story.
Yes. Well, and Geoff, so like you played the original, so you know that like the stuff, especially that Taro does with like his endings and the player interaction with that.
Yeah,
that's just like not something also, you could do in anime form. So
yeah, I played more of Drakengard than Nier. To be fair, it's just been on my like list forever. But like Drakengard 3 like blew my mind like 4 times in a row.
Oh, I know. Yeah.
It's just like.
If any of you in the chat have ever like wondered whether any of the Nier games are worth it, play them immediately. They're life changing. Incredible.
And if you have a tolerance for jank, play Drakengard too.
Yeah.
I've never played the game, but that looked really good. Like I would watch the anime for sure.
I mean, it got like everything right. The action looked great. The robots looked incredible. Mm-hmm. What we saw of 2B's ass was.
Okay, well, you can say that, but also there were some pretty good looking like dudes with no shirts on there.
Yeah, no,
Adam and Eve are looking pretty good.
Candy for all there.
Both of you should probably check out Drakengard 3 because it's literally just about like this power bitch running rampant over the world with her team of boy toys that she stole from all her sisters.
Yeah. And one incredibly lecherous old man, but yeah.
And one who's also a boy toy. Yes. Because he has a huge dick and that's like a canonical thing.
Oh my goodness.
It's worth it. It's worth
I'm
it.
Like, those were yeah. so good. I'm excited to see what we have.
All right. This is the last one.
Okay.
This is the
I
end.
Know what this one is.
I couldn't help myself. I had to put, you know, I had to save it for last.
This is a show that I've come to appreciate even more in its absence. And so having it back after all these years is just, it's going to be so incredible.
Oh, yes.
This song is nice.
I was just thinking that too.
Mappa just has to be stealing all of Studio Witch shows.
Ooh,
so good.
Really
good. And honestly, I know that people don't always love MAPPA's kind of house style approach when it comes to some of this direction. Yeah. I think that their weighty, grounded, kind of darker colored palette is really going to fit well with this show.
Yeah, it's definitely perfect for that specific world.
Mm-hmm. I mean, man, I don't know who to put on my list. I'm like trying to think.
Guys, that's all of the trailers. We survived.
Are we gonna do top 10 or top 5?
Top 5, I think. Okay. I think I can slim this down to top 5 pretty easy, to be honest.
I don't think I can.
Oh, really? Well, if you have to use 10 slots, because you can't cut anything.
Okay, I can do honorable. I can do top 5 with 2 honorable mentions. How about that?
Yeah. Okay.
5. Okay. Do you want to go first, Lynzee, or do you want me?
I need to look at my list a little bit to realize. Like,
okay.
Okay.
Oh shit.
You know, if I
forgot about this one.
Did you forget about Buddy Daddies?
I forgot about the Fire Hunter.
Oh, yeah.
So, no. Putty Daddies. Revenger and Putty Daddies are the top of this list. And Trigun. And it's all someone, I think Caitlin's like, Jacki's in heaven. Jacki's in undercut heaven. all the boys with my favorite haircut. I was like, oh my goodness. I did really like Fire Hunter. So I put Trigun for number one. I know people aren't thrilled about the CG, but like, I just got nostalgia overload.
Okay.
Yeah. So I just got nostalgia overload on that. So like, I put that to the top. I loved Revenger. Mm-hmm. Obviously, like, you know, samurai, great action. There were some attractive guys in there. Somebody said Jacki just likes blood and hot guys. And I was like, you know, that's kind of true. So I was like, it's true. I put Buddy Daddies up there. I thought that had a lot of action, even though it was kind of short. Yeah. And then I like Giant Beasts for sure. I thought that that one should definitely be in my top five. And then I put Tomo-chan, and I forgot what Tomo-chan was. Can you guys
remember? That was the tomboy who...
Oh, Tomo-chan's good. I would put Fire Hunter before Tomo-chan, though. So I'll put Fire Hunter to round out my top five. And then I would put Tomo-chan near in Vinland Saga in my, like, honorable mentions. Like, no offense, like, Vinland Saga we know is genius, but it's, like, the... What is it? Third season? Second season. So it's, like... I don't know. Like, I'm more intrigued by these new ones that I haven't seen, though. I guess Trigon's arguably not new, but okay. Vinland Saga, that's my list. I'm locking it in. Sorry. Yeah.
Right. I'm ready to give mine.
All right. Go ahead, Geoff.
Okay. Number one, Giant Beasts of Ours. Mm-hmm. That looks so good. Number two, Buddy Daddies. Gave me Spy Family vibes, I think. But also its own thing. I like that. Number three, Trigun Stampede. Just looks good.
I'm just going to do that whenever I agree.
all right. Number four, High Card. That one looked really fun tattoo powers, but they're cards.
Yeah, that was a good one.
Five, Trails of Cold Steel, War in the North. I still need to catch up on an entire very long video game in order to appreciate that story. But I will, because... I think that's so cool that they're like edge runnersing it and like telling a different story in the world instead of just, you know, copying it. Number six, Fire Hunter, because like that looks good. Seven, Adventurers Who Don't Believe in Humanity Will Save the World. That one
I put that one up there.
Yeah, shaping up good. Eight, Tomo-chan is a Girl. Nine, Nier Automata. And then I'm like, I have Sugar Apple Fairy Tale at 10, but like, I feel like maybe Revenger.
That's like the top of my list. Yeah. I like Revenger. Apple Fairy look good though. I agree with you.
It's just a lot of really, really not as promising as this season.
Last season that would be insane. Yeah, this season
we got a lot more unknowns this season. A lot of originals, a lot of things that, you know.
Which is fun, right?
Could like, be a new Akiba made war, or, you know.
Yeah. All right. Well, James, you go now.
All right. Yeah. Okay. So my top 10, roughly in order, I think. Number one, Beast of Ours. That one was that's the trailer that really made me go, oh, I need to see this. Mm-hmm. Number two, Trigun Stampede. I just want to watch Studio Orange do literally anything, and I will gladly sit down to watch it. Vinland Saga, Nier, Misfit Demon King Academy, season two.
Oh, right, yeah, season two.
High Card, Fire Hunter, Tomo-chan is a Girl, Buddy Daddies, and then my number 10 I actually gave to the Endo and Kobayashi because I want to see what that does with that
format. How that works.
That one did look good. There's so many that look good. It's frustrating.
Yeah, I actually had a really long list, but then I just tried to keep it short. But
yeah,
there's a lot to me that looked good with a question mark.
Yeah.
But didn't fully sell me, but got me intrigued enough to want to sit down and watch them.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
This is either going to be like a really good season or a really disappointing one.
Yeah,
I know.
I think the sequels and like some of the adaptations like Nier and Trigun will make it like there'll be enough to get us by, but Yeah, it's not going to be like this season.
People are going to wrote one of them twice, so I need
By
to...
the way, everybody, we're asking you to drop your top 10 in the chat, so make sure you do that. And then it's Lynzee.
Yeah, I just realized I made a mistake, so I'm going to go ahead and correct that. Okay. All right. So mine are, number one, I'm going to say Giant Beast of Ours. That was just, that was a dope trailer, and I hope it lives up to the hype. Number two, I'm going to give to Buddy Daddies, because I think that's going to be really good.
Yay.
Number three, I'm going to give to Trigun, because it's going to be a good time. That one's going to be a good time. Four, I'm going to give to Revenger. So that was my number four. And then number five, I'm giving to the Fire Hunter. So those are my picks. And then
that was mine. Yeah, really similar to mine.
Yeah. And then my bonus is Tale of Outcasts. I'm going to watch that furry show. I don't care what all y'all say.
I wrote that one down too.
High Card. Yeah. High Card.
High Card look good.
Campfire Cooking. Because
never watching
a show.
Really? That actually looked good for food, like a food anime.
Yeah,
but I'm like, it's just, I don't know. With all this a good action, like I'm like, I don't know if I'm gonna have time for it. So
Campfire Cooking was like close to the top of my. I got like 20 titles written down that I'm like interested in, but Campfire Cooking looked good.
And then I put a Sugar Apple Fairy Tale on there, and Nier.
Nice.
So those are mine.
We were all really similar on this one. I think sometimes we're a little different.
You didn't put did you put Tokyo Revengers?
I didn't. I actually saw all these people saying it and I was like, I should have. Like, so this is the thing. When it's a season two, I just kind of don't put it in there because like I like the originals, you know? Like I'm definitely excited to watch Tokyo Revengers. And I'm definitely I put Vinland Saga like in my honorable mention. Like real talk, like those two I'm probably gonna be the most excited to watch, right?
Yeah.
But it's like I just hate to put them in there when it's like there's these like promising new shows. So, but I'm definitely excited about Tokyo Revengers. I'm definitely excited about Trigun. So like, you know, and I guess like you could say that those are, you know, have been seen before. But you know what I mean. Yeah. So,
Nicholas Penerin. I hope I said your last name right. I want to know when winter season effectively starts. January 4th is when preview guide will launch, and that's also when the first shows will start premiering. So. I guess thank you everyone for tuning in. We made it again. We survived the longest trailer watch party, two YouTube malfunctions.
Yeah.
And me, I'm sorry for blowing out people's speakers. I was not ready for Trigun. I was not ready. So I'm sorry.
That was like the highlight of my evening, getting to see you get so.
Yeah, you were so excited.
I think for all of us, like that's such a part of our youth. I think we're all scared after like we've seen like the Cowboy Bebop debacle and like some other stuff, but it actually looked like solid to me. So I think I just got really, really excited. So yay. Anyway.
Thank you everybody. Yeah, thank everyone for being here. And make sure you check out, well, James and I will be back on Friday. The best of 2022. So if you want to hear what anime we thought was the absolute best this year, come on back here at 6 o'clock on Friday. We'll start publishing the best 2022 feature on Anime News Network that day. And I hope everyone just has a great new year and had a great holiday. And I appreciate you all for being here. So
yay, we appreciate
everybody.
Happy New Year.
Bye.